So we're back at it again. Klepto Jenny's on the job. They're gonna steal everything there is in Windhelm. So see Windhelm with the hawks. Wah! And now we go and steal everything. Because the town is poorer than Whiterun. Actually, this is the fourth time I'm starting this heist. We're gonna do the heist starting here.
Let's hope it's the last time.
Hopefully. We're gonna do the heist starting here at the end of the bridge. Going forward, so we're gonna do the guards. See, we have two guards patrolling the bridge. We have the stable boys. We're gonna rob him too. Ulundil, his name is. That was some bad English. Some very bad English.
What did you say? Say it again.
I don't know. Ulundil, his name is. Yeah. And the boy is a stable boy. He has a wife. Pretty high elf. We're gonna rob her too, because she's gonna start patrolling the other way of the bridge.
He's high elf or dark elf?
He's not dark elf. How can you say he's wood or high? I think he's high by his ability.
I don't know nothing about Skyrim, to be honest.
Yeah, I hope someday we'll get to know. Okay. Let's go first person. We're gonna take his cooked beef. Let's take everything he has. Stableski, you see. I think he's going to the barkeep in the lower districts. I'm gonna talk you through it. So we have the guard we have to do now, and there is a guard upstairs there. You see him? Aha, I already know. So let's pickpocket this guard. We saved, yes. I like how I can take the torches from his hand, you know. You have committed crimes against Skyrim and your people. One say in our defense. All right. And now I'm gonna try to steal everything one go. So. You see?
So it's more effective to take his torch first?
Yeah, because that's light, but I take it as it comes.
Wait, I know you.
Okay, let's go. Let's jump. I took everything from the guards. And there is his wife, Ulundil's wife. See how much they love each other. So when Ulundil leaves the home, his wife comes back. So they're pretty in love, right? This is how you make a relationship work. Never in the same room.
You have committed crimes against Skyrim. Yeah, I know.
They double team you.
Yeah, I saw, but now I cannot say persuade, see? So I there go, Skyrim. Die. So, no, prisoner. The thing is that you cannot persuade the same guard twice. So you can persuade other guards, but not the same guard twice. And I think if you're Thane, that works. I will try to do that in the next city, but to become Thane is... Some work involved, so, and I don't think we can become Thane without touching something in the city, you know? So that's what I'm thinking. Okay, I stole everything from her. Now we're going to a secret room.
It's a passage.
It's a passage, it's a room, man. Why you call it a passage?
Because it's a passage.
Okay, we'll see. So let the audience decide, is this a room or is this a passage? Vote now.
It's a passage to the resting rooms.
Where is the room?
You don't even know it.
The room should be here somewhere.
It's under the bridge. There. Yeah. You showed me before.
Yes, it's here. I found it. I think. Yes. So this is the secret room under the bridge.
This is a passage.
Secret passage under the bridge. Okay. So we have two wardrobes. But you see, you don't steal from them. So they don't belong to anybody. I'm going to show something fun later on. Try to tell me to remember about blood, yes, pretty funny thing. So this is a skill book, right? The bucket. So like Whiterun had different kinds of baskets, here we're gonna find different kinds of buckets. So they use more sturdy equipment right here, you know, but I think they use buckets to go to the bathroom, you know. Because there is a question, where do people shit in Skyrim? I think they shit in a bucket and then bury it. At least in Windhelm.
How do you know that?
Because they have shovels and buckets. I put one and one together. And I got that idea that they go to bathroom in the bucket.
That makes sense. That's a stretch, but okay.
Well, in Whiterun, the soil, you know, the soil is not that that hard, you know. So they could go in the bushes or something. But here, where it's always cold, Windhelm, you see, here, I think they shit in a bucket and then they bury it.
Nice theory.
This is my theory. Let me just... Come on. Okay. Now go... Okay, now you don't see me. Haha! So, let's steal everything we can. By the wood or the yard. Stop right there! Okay, persuade. All right. Now turn around. Ah, fuck it, I need to go. I should go two at a time. Don't be so hasty. So, I'll show you here a funny bit. So Bethesda is really lazy, as we all know, right? And the guards here are either twins or they just copy-pasted the same sprite.
Probably just copy-pasted.
Yeah, that's what I'll show you. What say you in your defense? I'm sorry. Right. Please turn around now. Okay. And now I'm... Aha! Next time, I did it! Might not be so lenient. So, we have this guard here. You see him? His name is... It's no secret the Aretino Jiminy Billy Bob. Let's call him that. I don't know his name. Brother. But this is his twin brother. Jiminy Billy Ray. Ah, talk to Aventus Aretino. I hate that kid. I don't hate him. I don't like...
Why does he say that? Right,
what, to meet him?
Yes.
Because he is invoking the Night Mother. So that is the starting quest next for the might not be so Dark Brotherhood.
Ah, I see.
Aha! We did it! We did it!
This time was a bit faster.
Yeah, because I knew the trick. So see? This is Jiminy Billy Bob and this is Jiminy Billy Ray. See? Either the same guy or twins.
Probably the same guy.
Yeah, I think so too. You know what? I'm curious. If he catches me... No, because we tried that. So, they're not connected. Because he caught me, then I could persuade him. Then he caught me, then I would persuade him. So, they are different entities.
They're called different.
I don't know if they're called different, but different entities. Because I could persuade them both, you know? And I told you, you cannot persuade the same guard twice. Their code is the same, yeah. Wanna hear a bit of funny trivia?
Yes.
The... So you can buy mannequins, you know, to put in your house so you can equip them with your armor and things like that, you know?
To display?
To display, yes. But actually, they're not mannequins, they're Nords, like that Nord. Just hard-coded to stay still and don't say anything. And sometimes the code breaks. And
they move?
Yeah, they move and start talking to you. Yeah, pretty strange. That's pretty scary things to see. Okay, Silda the Unseen.
Who is this?
This is a beggar. She's a trader, trainer in sneaking. She's a beggar. And her schedule is pretty nice. So she stays here to get some warmth, right? She runs from there to here to get some warmth. Then at some point during the day, she will run from that point where she is now. To that point to get that point right over there to get some heat, you know. But she runs every time. She doesn't walk. So her character.
And she needs to keep her body warm.
Yeah, you're right. But why doesn't she stay in one place like there or something? I don't know. But she runs. She runs every time. I found that pretty funny. Always running. Always on the run. Silda the Unseen is always on the run. A pretty funny thing. So I steal this. Okay. Silda, don't look at me, Silda. Silda. I ask only for a little charity. No, don't use the workbench. Okay, go back. Oh, I don't like it when because of you. She sees me because of the source of light. It's very not nice. Windhelm is harder to pillage than Whiterun, actually. Okay, well, let's jump. Now there's a man here, see? Sometimes it's a man, sometimes he's a woman. So the trick is to go behind him, go like that, and now you're hidden.
Oh, the last time was a woman.
Yeah, now he's a man. So they change. Okay. Let's take all of them.
by order of the
No problem. I persuade you. Persuade.
All right.
Okay.
You just watch yourself.
Watch yourself. Next time, I'm not going to be so lenient. Another guard.
I know you.
I know you know me. I'm in the shadows now, so I can.
You have committed crimes against Skyrim and her people.
What say you, in your defense? Here, persuade.
All right.
Okay,
you
let's
just
try
watch
again.
Yourself. You have committed
Come on,
crimes
man.
Skyrim.
No, no. This is all how it goes. So, characters are a bit harder to steal from, pickpocket. I have 90% chance to pickpocket any item. And this is how they calculate the 90% chance. Okay, steal everything.
By order okay. of the yard. Stop,
stop right there. Okay.
All right.
I don't know why he said by the order of the yard, because the yard did not. Okay, just hide. It did not catch me, so he didn't know to give order. He's somebody spots me. Okay, now. Okay, bye bye, Windhelm guard. Okay, let's steal everything from the shop. I think I can take things from barrel without stealing, yes. So that is good. And let's make ourselves little. This is how I call sneaking. There's a bottle there. Aha, I almost forgot that last time. And steal everything.
Do you have a plan how to approach everything?
Yeah, I'm gonna start. Well, you can help me by opening a...
I mean, too late for that.
Why not? I just stole from three people. We can do it. I had that that made. I know all the characters. Although... So that could be okay.
So we can do a list or something?
Yeah, there is a, you can go NPCs from Windhelm. There are 40-60 NPCs and just cross them off. And we stole from three NPCs until now. So that we can do that now if you want. If you want to be thorough. But after that, you still have to cross everyone off. So I don't know. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Somebody's. Saw me.
The old-fashioned way, the best way.
Ulundil, his wife, and Silda Dansin. His wife was named as Aranaya, something like that. Some shit like that, I think. So I took everything from the basket. No, better here. Like a flower. I don't know how he's... I'm gonna quick save more often. Okay, save. See like that. So Silda Dansin, Urundil, and Arinaya, something like that, is his wife. The Ulundil's wife, or whatchamacallit. Okay, leg of a goat, horse meat. They sell horse meat there, you see. Horse meat, steal salmon, come on.
In Wildrun, there wasn't horse meat, right?
Yeah, there was horse meat, I think.
And, just one?
Yeah, one and dog meat. Just a little bit of dog meat somewhere. We're gonna find dog meat here too. Where is the salmon? Where is the salmon? Where is the salmon? Okay. We took everything from there. Okay. No, we have one more salmon. Salmon. Okay. So now we took everything. Let's go to this. Take the cheese. I posted some graphs on Reddit. And people asked me, but how about cheese? How much
yeah,
cheese?
Yeah, I've seen some memes with cheese.
Yeah, it's recurrent because Sheo Gorat, man. Sheo Gorat likes cheese. That's why in the last video, don't you remember me just shouting cheese all over and over again?
Yes, it was a little weird.
Nah, it's because of the meme. Sheo Gorat likes cheese a lot.
I see.
And in Oblivion, Sheo Gorat's mission is to make a town think the apocalypse has come, you know, and start making. They have three signs of apocalypse, and you need to do two of them, and then Shogorat is gonna take care of the third, you know. And one of the quests involves you getting a really smelly
cheese,
a round of cheese, yes. And the third one, it's pretty funny quest. The third one is dead. Dogs falling from the sky. So he makes that because you cannot make dogs falling from the sky. Pretty funny quest. That's why Shogorat is a fan favorite of the series. And some say, what do you think in the comments? Leave a comment. He is the strongest of the Daedra princes. So, I think he's strong, and there is some lore and books of how he beat the other Daedra princes in wits contests. But I don't know, the strongest? Gigalag will be the strongest, I think. He will be the strongest, although he doesn't appear in Skyrim. I think that is pretty bad, but I think he will gain his full power at some point in the future. So, you know who Gigalag is?
No, I have no idea what you're talking about.
Gigalag is the alter ego of Shogorath. So, because Gigalag was the strongest of the Daedric princes, he was cursed by all the other princes to become insane. So he became Shogorath. He was the prince of order.
So Shogorath is his alter ego.
Shogorath is his alter Gigalag's alter ego, yeah. But you break the curse in Oblivion and you become Shogorath. So the character you play in Oblivion, the character you play in the Elder Scroll for Oblivion is actually Shogorath in this game. Because he mounts his place.
That's very confusing.
If you know the lore, not so much. So there is a thing called mounting in this universe. So you mount a place of a god, you walk like him, act like him, and in time you become him. Whatchamacallit, Champion of Kovach, the character in Elder Scrolls 4, after the game ends, becomes Shogorath.
Ah, I see.
And in this game, you meet Shogorath for his Daedric Prince quest. But the Shogorath you meet here is not the Shogorath you met in Oblivion. The Shogorath you meet here is actually the player character from Elder Scrolls.
I see.
So that's the thing. Like in this game, canonically speaking, after you finish this game, the player should, by all means, remain in the Hermaeus Mora Apocrypha, in Hermaeus Mora's Plane of Oblivion, because he became his new champion. Because, think about it, the game needs a canonical end for the champion. Here you play as the legendary Dragonborn, right?
Yes.
So how do you explain lore-wise what the Dragonborn did after the game ends, or what the Champion of Kovach did after the game ends? Either you kill him, or you make him go someplace that he could not bother anybody, you know? Okay, I need to start the mission before, because if not, they will not stop arguing about things.
Look, please, don't.
Okay, so I started the White Phial. The White Phial is a mission for a potion that refills herself itself.
Useless assistant. You have to do the mission?
No, I need to start the mission, otherwise they would have... went on arguing, you know?
I see.
So that's why I needed to talk with him to stop the... They will argue, but they will... Not about that. Ah, they saw me! They saw me! Not about that. I have a theory here in this house. I'll tell you about it. So, if you finish this guy's quest line, he will die, the alchemist, the old guy. There's no way it's that precise. Because that is his lifetime dream, to become, to get the White Phial. So, if you complete the mission, he will die. And I think his apprentice wants to kill him.
Don't waste time apologizing. Just find the
he wants to kill him.
Why?
Why? I'll tell you why. Because he helps you find the phial. So that's one of the things. And the second is, look at this. Look at this floorboard. He's old, man. He's decrepit, right? He could fall and sleep anytime. And look at this floorboard. So why doesn't he help his master, you know? Just put some wood there, some planks. Yeah, he wants to kill him. That's my theory. That is my theory. Otherwise, he would have fixed the house.
Don't say such things.
He has, you see the... No, man, you cannot... sideburns. You see the sideburns of this guy?
Yes.
You cannot trust somebody with those kinds of sideburns, man. Just saying. The White Phial key. I got his key. Another fun bit about this shop. Oh, fuck you. Fuck. Another fun tidbit about this shop is that it is always open. I think it's the only shop in Skyrim that is always open 24 hours a day. No, you know.
Why is that?
I'm sorry.
Why is that? I don't know why is that.
Reading up on the effects.
Maybe they're using some kind of potions to not sleep.
No, because they sleep.
Ah, they sleep?
Yeah, at some point, yeah. And there is another shop in Skyrim. I think that is non-stop, but we need to double check. An alchemy shop also in the rift. There is a wife and a husband managing the shop, and they take turns sleeping, you know?
I mean, that makes sense.
Yeah, this is the second skill book for all you guys trying to find skill book. Okay. No, come on. I'd rather die than go to jail. See, I cannot persuade him because I already persuaded him outside. So he's the same guard. See, now his clothes. Yeah, Todd Howard, when you leave the region, Todd Howard gives them back their clothes, you know?
Himself?
Yeah, Tom Howard himself. He's a god, man. He's the messiah of this universe, and he just walks around giving clothes to everybody. Okay, take this. Take that. Take the pot. I want to make the pot joke again, you know? Becoming a pot dealer. Giant lichen. Heal, I guess. Okay. And now here. Ooh, you look at the plunder. Another fun bit about Windhelm is that there are lots and lots of potions everywhere. So I think there are less drinks, like alcoholic beverages, but lots and lots of potions everywhere. I think it's because of the war, and this it would make sense because this city is, more involved in the war, in the civil war. So it would make sense that they are fully prepared. So in Whiterun there were 60 potions to be had in total. 60 potions in total.
Ah, in total?
Yeah, 60 in the whole city.
That's very low.
Yeah, but here there are a lot of potions. So we'll see. We'll see about that. Okay, let's jump. Nothing there. We took everything from here. So... there are two unique items here. One I already stole. It is Nurelion's. We're just gonna find him at N. Where is it? I think it's a food. And Batman. Or he.
Maybe in Misk?
Yeah, maybe in Misk. I did stole it. I did Nurelion
mixture.
Yes,
there it is.
See? So this is the first item. And this is the second unique item here. Wilandriach Soldier Gem. Yeah.
What do you do with this?
It's a quest I think you receive from the mage in... a court mage in Riften to bring it back.
Ah, I see.
But you know, in a classic Bethesda quest line, it's just bring me that. And you just come here, take it and... See the shovel! Told you about going to bathroom, so you have the shovel and buckets.
The bucket.
Yeah, I think this is how they go to the bathroom.
Yeah, makes sense.
Yeah, see, so we fix that mystery. A lot of gourds, some potatoes. Okay, everything is done here. So this is the bed where the apprentice sleeps.
And the master sleeps above?
Yeah, upstairs. That's why, you know, that's why he should fix the floors.
Nah, I think it's just he wants to keep an eye on him.
From upstairs?
Yeah.
Yeah, see, you can see downstairs. Oh, while he wanks off or something like...
So he can sneak and do something illegal.
Like what, man? What are you talking about?
I don't know. Some mix of potions, I don't know.
I think he just likes to watch his apprentice wank off once in a while.
From below?
From above. So another thing, another fun fact, is that don't sit at the tables, is that I don't know why a lot of apple pies are on the ground. I don't know why. So this is the first apple pie on the ground. We're gonna find some other apple pies on the ground. I don't know why they keep it. In the last video, I told you we
wait, that piece of cloth, can you take it?
What? What?
On the table.
No, the cloth?
Yes.
No, that I cannot read.
Ah, okay.
So, we talked about bottles of wine with no basket. There are no baskets in the city. I don't understand. Some of it have baskets. Most of them do not have baskets. So that was not a unique. That was a unique item for Whiterun.
Yes, in Whiterun was just one without basket.
But here apparently they don't afford baskets, or they don't like baskets. There are a few baskets here. So let's just open the strong box. Some dude asked me when I posted the graph on Reddit if I stole all the thieves' cash from the city. I did not even know there is such a thing as thieves' cash in the city.
Thief cash, was that?
Is when you finish the main quest of the all the quests actually from the Thieves Guild.
Yes.
And the main quest, they open thieves' cash all over the Skyrim. It's a box with high-end level loot, you know.
I see.
But no thieves' cash because we did not finish any kind of mission in this playthrough. So we just maxed our character and then start stealing stuff, because we don't want anything to be out of its place, you know.
Makes sense.
Yeah, because maybe, you know, while doing a full playthrough, you steal something, especially for the Thieves Guild. Think about it. You have to come in the city and steal some stuff, you know. So no thieves' cash done. It's okay.
Wait, you can sell that.
What?
The skull.
No, I cannot.
Ah, it's empty.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. It's okay. Empty. Okay.
I cannot. Oh, here. These things. I almost forgot. So let's go.
What's that? Is that a rat?
Rabbit, man.
No.
This one?
Yes.
A pheasant.
No, that one.
Pheasant.
Ah, rabbit.
Rabbit and pheasant. And garlic. You don't know how rabbit look like.
I mean...
Man, I think you only saw Bugs Bunny when you're little and you think they all look like Bugs Bunny. But
yeah, let's go with that.
Yeah, that's what I think. Okay, so I stole everything, right? Everything from this place. Yeah, you can you have a pen and paper? You took a pen and paper?
Yes.
Okay, so write down Norelion, write him off.
Yes, he's written off.
And his apprentice,
Quintus
Navale. Quintus Navale, I think he's Italian or something. Is he Italian?
Probably not.
Do you know Italian?
No, a little.
Yeah, I know some. I know pasta. Pizza, tarantella, hey, see? God. Three words already.
That's a lot.
Polizia, that's... No, they say...
That's not how they say it in Italy.
Carabinieri.
Yes, carabinieri, yes.
Yeah, carabinieri, see? See, I don't know. So I stole from him, but Todd Howard just gave him back his clothes. Okay, I almost forgot the shield here, see? See what you made me do? Forget the shield. I took it now. So let's go back to heisting. So we did the White Phial. This we cannot do.
Silla, who's Silda?
Silla is dancing. We already robbed her.
Ah,
put
I see.
It on the list.
Silla, yes. Yeah.
We cannot rob the blacksmith right now.
Why?
Because he never sleeps. Let me show you. He never sleeps. Yeah, there is something funny in this city, actually, about sleeping. Spouses, you know. Married the character and such. See? He does not sleep. He never sleeps.
And how can you steal from him?
How can I rob him?
Yeah.
While he's at work.
I see.
So, while he works, I will rob him. But I can steal now from him. I think just his items and shit. You know, but and I don't know why he sees me very well. So I saw that some characters are able to see you better than other characters, you know. And such guards can see you better. Thieves can spot you better.
I mean, they are trained.
Yeah. So he sees me very, very well, this guy here. Let's start robbing this place while he cooks. Another funny thing in this house is the particle effect. See? I don't know what's this. I always look. See?
What particle effects.
Don't see it. Look at this.
That's a texture, pretty much.
No.
Yeah, it's a texture.
But you see?
Yes, I see.
Like it's not. So here we have the shovel again. Told you, man. So, shovels. Shovels. Buckets. Lots of buckets. Okay. He is pretty good at spotting me, so we have to be careful. Is there something up there? No, nothing up there. Okay, let's take his tomatoes while he cooks. The blacksmith is pretty rich, but that's normal considering he is the blacksmith for the whole the central operation of the Stormcloak.
So he's the official blacksmith.
Yeah. The OG.
Steal what he's cooking?
What he's cooking? No. You cannot steal if characters are doing something. You cannot steal that from. See, he saw me. I don't know why. I need to leave because he will be very mad. But I stole everything from downstairs, right?
What's his name?
Oengul or something. We'll go back in the house and.
I mean, it doesn't matter much.
Well, it matters a bit because I wanted to talk about this. Is the names of characters? I like them.
Don't even think about it. Working in Windhelm is great. I get to see Ulfric up close.
Everyone says Yorland Greyman.
So I stole everything from him, but I told you Todd Howard gives him his shit back. So this is his apprentice. I don't know if they're married. Let's see her name. So her name is Strongheart, and his name is Waranvil. I like the names of Norwich.
Yeah, probably they're not related.
But they sleep in the same house. They sleep in the same house. But you can overhear them arguing about Hermir using his forge. Oh, come on. So, I don't know. Maybe they're just co-workers.
Probably.
Yeah, but the guy never sleeps. And the girl, you know, she sleeps upstairs. But talking about sleeping. In this city, there are only four characters that sleep together. Come on.
By order of the Jarl,
stop right there. I can persuade her.
All right.
But I don't want. I'll just load the game. So, in this city, guards teleport like in Cyberpunk. So you saw how the guard just entered the room? It was like, just there. Revert the legendary dragons, blah, 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 blah.
I think I saw.
It's the other way around. In Cyberpunk, they teleport like Skyrim.
You committed crimes against Skyrim and her people.
What's saying you in defense?
All right.
Okay,
but
bye-bye.
Just watch yourself.
Okay, someone is using this. No, I could. Should I leave it like this? Let's try it again. And if she catches me again, I'll...
Wait, what happened?
The guard entered. Just as
I saw that, but why?
I persuaded the guard to leave me alone, and then all the NPCs become friendly again.
Ah, okay.
Look behind the forge. I think I saw it there.
Okay, let's do it like that. Okay, so I took the ring. That was problematic. Let's take that too. Okay, bye bye. So we could do it at. I never achieved doing it at night, but now I did. That's a new one. Okay, let's take everything from upstairs. So see, lots of battles without the basket in this city, and the floors, man. The floors in this city are like so beautiful. I don't know. You know what I find it strange? They don't have basements.
Why? Probably they don't have enough wood.
But basements?
That's strange.
Yeah, in Burma or what?
Especially because it's in the north, where it's very cold.
Yeah, and they should have basements. I don't understand this. This is awkward. See? They have two chairs next to the fireplace. So I think they stay around, talk, but one bed. And
I mean, they want to be cozy.
Yeah, but the blacksmith doesn't have a bed. So Bethesda fucked that up there when they did not give a bed to the blacksmith. I don't know why.
Maybe there's a hidden reason.
Yeah, what?
I don't know. Just Todd Howard knows it.
Yeah, he knows it, but he does not say. Okay, still the book, still that book there. Every time there's a book there, but different book. Different kind of book. So let's see. We took you remember White Run. There were lots and lots of things. Here, just a few things.
Yeah, it's pretty empty.
Yeah, it's pretty empty. But all in all, I think we're gonna make more money here. I'll show you in the next house. Why do I mean that? In the crypt. We're going to the crypt!
Can you sell the fur?
What fur? Where fur?
On the wall.
No. There are
Look
some fur.
At the right?
There? No. There are some furs you can steal, but not,
you cannot.
Not this. Okay, bye-bye. Bye-bye, Oengul, and bye-bye, a Strongheart. I don't know how they name themselves Nord, you know? Like, why is she Strongheart? Like, what would be your Nord name?
I don't know.
Mine would be...
The Viking.
The Viking, you have to be two words every time. Like Battleborn, or, you know? Greymane, Cruel Sea, you know? Strongheart, things like that.
Poor old woman.
So why do you have... I'll steal the clothes, but just that. I don't know why do you have it. Why does he have it? Because we stole everything from him. Just the clothes. Okay. We won't steal the armor anymore. So, see? Cruelty. Thorsten. You can cross Thorsten now. If we caught him here. Thorsten.
You have committed crimes against Skyrim.
Skyrim and our people. What's saving your defense? Oh, load game. Thorsten. Okay. Cruelty. Wiggly arms. Let's go for Snail, wiggly arms. Ah, that's funny. Let's see. Viola Giordano. I'm gonna tell you some trivia about her when we get to her. She never sleeps.
How do you know that? Have you followed her or something?
Yeah. I tried to rob her during the night and she's just cooking about like...
Who's that?
The priest right there? It's a priest. Hellgrid. We're gonna rob from her too. Just a second to finish with our friend Thorsten here. Thorsten. He sees me. Okay.
Hey!
I like how he just attacked me. Hey! This is my ring. Give it back.
Why don't you steal the ring first?
I'm gonna try. I think it doesn't matter. It's just.
See?
Okay. I did it. Okay, take the flowers, all the flowers, all the flowers. So nightshade only grows where death is present. You can write that down. Okay, let's see. There is here. Let's steal from the priest afterwards. Some nightshade here. We can do some things during the day in this city. That is good, so we don't have to wait the night. Okay, let's steal from Hagrid. Filthy thief! So, there's a quest here with a serial killer. Viola Giordano is pretty crazy about him. She patrols the White Quarters, the Grey Quarters, in order to find him and gives out pamphlets about him, about the serial killer.
Why is she so worried?
I don't know, she doesn't like a serial killer being in the city. I mean, it's common sense.
She's the only one?
She's the most involved in it. You know?
There's Maybe she's like a aficionado detective or something like that.
Hear my prayers. Nightshade. So, is this the one? No, not this. So this is a wall of lots of names. I think they are here. The companions that came with Isgromor, you know, and slaughtered all the snow elves. The names are here, I think. Okay. So we stole everything from here. We took the plants, the nightshade from the cemetery. Now we're going into the crypt. There is a barrel here and some nightshade here still. So, why do we get more money from this city, although it's poorer? The reason is, we are max level. And here, in comparison to Whiterun...
I mean, we were max level before, right?
Yeah, but in Whiterun, there are not a lot of containers with leveled loot, you know? So there are some containers that have level loot, that the loot evolves with your level. That's what level loot is. And in Whiterun, we don't have lots of those. But here, in Windhelm, we have these knapsacks all over the place, you know? And these containers always scale with your level. So we can find here, you see? Things like this.
I see.
And this plunder is not very, very good, but you'll see in the next knapsacks, you can find items that are worth 2,000 septims or something. So it's pretty... pretty good to rob, only when you're max level. So keep that in mind when you open knapsacks in the city. Okay, so wardrobe, see? Just a few things all over the place. Nothing much. Okay, this looks like... so this is the oldest city in Skyrim. Fun trivia. And this is why we have this old Nordic ruin underneath. Because it's from that time. So we have to steal here some bowls and touch goblets maybe. But just that. That's everything. There's some bucket for the priest to go to the toilet.
Where are the guards?
Why there should be guards in here?
I know. There's value things.
No, there weren't. There was a bowl and a goblet. That's all. See? There's nothing here. Absolutely nothing here worth stealing. So just empty space. We had that knapsack. Let's get some... A blessing from Arcades upon you! So now we can leave. You know? That was it. So nothing much here. Nothing of value here. Okay. Now we can go to the upper quarters of the town. Do you remember Gothic 2? Have you played Gothic 2? With the upper... there was in the first town you enter. Before entering the upper quarters, you needed to become a citizen of the city, you know? Only then you can enter the upper quarters. So who has that hat? I know who has that hat. He's a seller from the marketplace. We're gonna rob him too, I think. Let's see. Before he gets to the marketplace. Because if he gets to the marketplace, it's gonna be pretty tough to rob him. And here we have shadows. So let's become invisible. Yes. Now we are invisible. We just disappeared. This elf has really nice hair. Really, really nice hair.
What's his name? Avalon.
Aval Atheron. Now he's naked, Aval. Hat. See? His hair.
His ponytail.
Yeah, he's like Geralt. I am a witcher. Aval, you naked, go to marketplace. Let's see if we can rob everybody from the marketplace. Let's go. Where is that wall?
Is this a hidden wall or something?
It is a pretty fun wall. It is a bug. Pretty fun bug. One wall bleeds in the city. It actually bleeds when you hit him. It. So he levy cruelty. Okay. I robbed your husband, right? Tolts. What was his name? I'll rob you after dark. Okay. I can do it. I can do it from here. Can I? Hilevi, don't look at me.
She sees you.
Who looks at? Who see? Oh,
the
okay.
Guard.
No, not the guard. Maybe the guard. But I need to steal from the guard too, because he has a weapon. So that is a new guard. I can do it from on top of the barrel, I think. I think there is on top of this barrel. I can. No, the lightning. The lightning makes me visible, but I can rob... this girl, because we have shadows here, I think. So this character, Niranye. No, I'm gonna rob her at night or something. I'm gonna rob her. So another guard.
Wait.
I know you. Let's see. Now we're gonna rob them during night time, because see, the lighting here is very bad for stealing. Okay, let's go to the upper quarters. So Niranye, that high elf I was talking about, she's the fence for the Thieves Guild. Now working in cahoots, with another thieving organization of high elves that is situated in a cave near here.
I see.
And explain to me this. Why does the plant grow on fences? on concrete. I don't understand that. Yeah, there's no soil that is beyond me. So for this it is, but I'll show you. So see, let's go up. Let's say here we have soil in the back. So yeah, but I'll show you where we have no kind of soil.
Okay. Nature always finds a way.
Yeah, just to concrete. Okay, jumping grab, Jackbinger. Jumping grab, Jackbinger. Okay, I took it. Now go to the other side. So during the day we'll take all the plants, right? Because the plants are easy to take. See here. Look here. See, it grows on the fence.
I see.
Bethesda, get your shit together. So we were talking about what kind of mountain flower they prefer in Whiterun. And it panned out it was
purple.
Yes, but here they like red mountain flower. So see, all of the mountain flowers are red, but I need to jump over that. Yes, okay, to get here. This is I don't know why I jump better in third person, you know. Okay, we done it.
Better special awareness, I think.
Yeah, maybe. But no, we got it. Okay, some barrels. We can steal from the barrels too. Okay, let's see. Let's take all the plants. A guard. Wait. You with your blonde, beautiful hair, you.
He saw you.
He did not see me. You scared me. Hello there. Hello, my friend guard. So let's take all the plants, some berries and some hanging moss. I'll show you a trick afterwards how you can make lots of money at the start of the game coming to the city. Lots of money. Okay, let's see here. So do you know which is the most expensive potion to brew?
No.
You don't know it, I'll tell you. The most expensive potion to brew is one made out of wheat, giant's toe and creep cluster. And giant's toe is pretty hard to come by. I mean, you need to kill a giant. And when you're low level, it's pretty hard to kill a giant, right?
What do you do with that potion?
You make it and sell it. Damage health. That is the most expensive potion you can.
I see.
I mean, you can make another one more expensive, but only with the Heartfire DLC. And you need some fish eggs that you can get from your houses. But in the vanilla game, the most expensive potion you can ever make is Creep Cluster, Giant's Toe, and Wheat. And I told you, Giant's Toe is pretty hard to come by. And there is a place in the city where you can get two of those just by picking them up. So pretty neat trick to know if you want to make some quick bucks when you start the game, you know. I thought I saw some flowers there. I did see some flowers there. You know the reference?
No.
It's from Sylvester and Tweety, man. I thought I saw a putty cat. I did saw a putty cat. Really, didn't know it?
No.
You don't have a childhood. Here is the Hieronym. You can buy this house after you finish the quest with the serial killer. But I was watching yesterday a top of Machinima or Game Ranks or something, you know?
You watch Machinima?
Something like that. I don't know, Game Ranks I think it was. And it was, Game Ranks because it was Falcon. So, and it was 10... strange things you can find in Skyrim. I mean, strange, weird, you know, creepy. So what were we talking about? We're talking about these houses here. Okay. I think the best thing to do is steal everything from this house. This is Viola Giordano's house. She's Italian. She really is Italian. I mean, the name is Italian. Let's go in. She's the lady crazy with the serial killer. There's a serial killer. See, look here. We have the knapsack. Let's see what we got here. See? 300 gold. So yeah, pretty good loot in these knapsacks.
She's rich.
No, she's not rich. She's level gold in knapsacks. They have a lot of knapsacks. I don't know why. I think because of the war, right? They are prepared to flee at any time. Yeah, see? The buckets. The buckets everywhere, the buckets! The buckets are present. Let's take everything we have here. We have the thingy. So Viola Giordano lives alone. Maybe that's why she's so scared of the serial killer. You know, because she's a lonely lady in the big city.
Who's the serial killer?
We're gonna go there. It's Calixto. Calixto. He's actually one of the few quests you can do wrong in Skyrim. I think the only one. I think it's the only quest.
You can fail?
Not fail, because you can fail some quests. You can get the wrong serial killer.
Ah.
You can accuse
And
them.
Someone else can go to prison in his place?
Yes.
That's you can, actually funny.
Yeah, you can accuse the Jarl's wizard of being the serial killer, which he is not. But the quest, this is one of the buggiest quests in Skyrim. It's beyond any salvation. It's actually the best way to get infinite money at the start of the game, doing that quest. Because what you can do is get an amulet that is worth 1,000 gold, sell it to the serial killer, then pickpocket the amulet from him, then sell it back and so such and such.
So and it only works with him?
Yeah, because it's an item that you give him, then you can take it back, then you can give him back to him and so on. You do not sell it as a shop owner, you know, like at the shop. You just give it to him.
I see.
So yeah, you can do that. If you want infinite money, that's the way to go. So see these hides. This is a hoe. We cannot steal hoes in this game. That is sad. There was a hoe in Oblivion, a very unique hoe that was gave you STDs. Yeah, it's an Easter egg in one expansion pack from Oblivion. There was a hidden hoe, but very, very well hidden, that gave you all the diseases in Skyrim. Even the wielder had the chance to get diseased from her. Eat. So, you know, hoes give you STDs, just saying. A pretty fun Easter egg. And it had no unusual name, and the enchantment was not visible, you know. It was just a hoe hidden somewhere that gave you STDs. So, yeah. Hoes give you STDs. So let's take
care. If you take the hoe and you give it to another character.
Does he take the STDs?
Yes.
I don't remember how was the companion thingy in Oblivion. I don't think you could give it to somebody like here. Have a companion and you can give the items to him, to them, you know? Armor and such. But in Oblivion, I don't remember that mechanic being there. Which is a sad thing. Let's see. So, some antlers. Right there. No, let's go into her room. So, what I told you. Lots of potions. Lots of potions in the city. See? Carrots, sacks, red apples. Wine. So she's rich enough to have a basket on her wine bottle. Let's see here. Lots of books. I'm curious if the lectures, I mean the books they read here, are very different from the ones in Whiterun.
Probably.
They should be. I mean, they should be more of a patriotic, you know, more like books about the North and such. Okay, let's steal the bucket. I don't like this chest. Okay. Everything is nice. And the table. Let's take everything from it. And some gold coin. So this is the sink, you know, where they wash their face. They should add some water to it. Okay, so everything has been taken care of upstairs. And now we just need to rob Viola Giordano and we're done. So this house is better to do during the day. That's what I'm saying. Okay. Because we can find Viola any day patrolling the streets. Giving out pamphlets about the serial killer. Now we wait until the night. Let's quick save before that and wait until the night. Because we work better in the night. We are Klepto Jenny. The thief. Haha. Yes. Okay, so it's 10 p.m. Let's go until 11 p.m. Hopefully, what's the clan's name here? Clan Shatter-Shield, because they shatter shields. But the door was open, so I guess they're not in bed. Okay. So, talking about sleeping habits in this city, I think Ulfric is compensating for something. Really, I think he's compensating for something, you know? The people here are very prude. They don't sleep together. Maybe it is a law or something for the spouses not to sleep together. There are only two couples that sleep together in the city. One in the inn and two priests.
Two priests?
Yeah, that's funny. That's a funny fact. See another knapsack. So here, look here. 700 gold. Ooh, from one knapsack. So that's why I'm saying that maybe the loot will actually be better in this city. So yeah, the priests and I think a hoe and someone from the bar. They sleep together, but just that. The priests. The priests know what's up, you know? They do a little bit of Dibella worshipping, if you get my drift, you know? You get my drift?
No.
come on, man. Dibella is the god of sex and, you know, debauchery, whatchamacallit. And if you worship Dibella, you're just a hoe fucking everybody.
So is that canon lore?
Yeah, that is canon lore. There is a hoe in an actual very promiscuous lady in Riften that sleeps with everybody in the town that has a statue of Dibella, because I told you, she's a Dibella worshipper. So that is her credence to just sleep with everybody around.
I see.
So another thing, you know, the more you know.
The more you know, yes.
Yeah. You can put a meme. The more you know, a meme like that. So let's go upstairs. The lady is not home. We're gonna wait for her. Ah, this is the daughter. So the serial killer murdered this lady's sister. You can cut Nilsin off the list. Nilsin Shatter-Shield. Nilsin, just stay there. Just don't mind
if
me.
You don't catch the killer, does he start
murder again?
Yes.
Yeah, he murders again. Yeah,
who
it's
is
like
his
in
first
the Witcher. I don't know who is his first target. I don't know how you trigger that quest actually. I need to talk with somebody about the killer, and then the killer will hit again, killing somebody, you know, and then you can get on his tracks.
So
and
he's like Jack the Ripper, something like that.
Yeah, something like that. But what he does is he murders young women and then he chops their body and tries to build his former lover again, you know?
Like so a little necromancy.
Some sort of necromancy, but I don't think he's skilled enough. He is a little bit of an occult, collectioner. He has a museum here.
He has a museum?
Yeah, of occult things. We find one of the funniest. You saw me. I'm leaving. Don't worry. Don't call the guards.
Go before they come.
Yeah, I know. It's a matter of time. Okay, let's wait for an hour. I think now she goes to sleep.
Okay. Look at them.
Look at the guard. No, he doesn't have a weapon, so we stole from him.
But he has a shield.
We don't pickpocket. He saw me. I don't know how he saw me. Okay, let's enter.
That's how you know if he doesn't have a sword.
If he doesn't have a weapon, we stole from him.
Oh, I see.
So this is Torbjorn. You can cross him off the list.
What do you think?
I'm stealing from you, asshole. What do you think I'm doing? And you caught me. So his daughter got murdered. See, but you see, the father of the house sleeps here. So he doesn't sleep with the spouse. That's a little bit strange.
Makes sense.
After so much time, yeah, they sleep separately.
I mean, the murder of a child shatters a family.
Ah, that's what you're saying. Maybe. But I told you, nobody sleeps here together with the spouses. So this is the custom.
Or maybe they don't want to be with each other if the assassins come from one of them.
Good thing to do, right?
Of course.
Just let one of them die.
Of course.
Yeah, pragmatic way of thinking. So we stole everything from downstairs. We stole everything from Nilsson's room. We got the unusual gem there. So for those that go for Baron Zaya's gems, we got one here. Okay, let's do that. Let's do everything. The shovel, you know. For the bathroom, you know what I'm saying? So this is the matron of the house. See? She sleeps separately from the husband. I told you. I cannot take that. Let's see, everything is here. After this, so we got the market district, right? It's done. We got the upper quarters. We have one more house there. And then we can move to the lower court. No, to the inn. To the inn. We're going to... Let's steal from her. We can undress her. Tava, Tower Shield. You can cross her off.
Tova.
You little thief. I'm not little. I'm big. I'm a big lady. The Thalmor. First, I was afraid. I was petrified, you know. Kept thinking I could never live without you by my side.
Stop singing.
It's funny. But then I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong. Then I grew strong. let's go. I learned how to get along and turn your back. Okay, let's go. So we stole everything from this house. See, but there are a few things here, man. They're not rich. In Whiterun, there were lots and lots of items. Here, not so much. But maybe all their wealth goes into the war effort, you know, for the Stormcloaks. So that could be it. Draugr. I saw a nice meme. It was on Reddit. It was a Draugr just waking up from his slumber, and it was with the caption, "What are you doing, step Draugr?" You know?
Damn Draugr.
Yeah, that was funny. Okay, let's see here. This is the house with the murderer, right? And this is our barrel. We took everything.
So this is his house?
No. I'll show you. We're gonna get there. Don't worry about it. We're gonna take Isgromor's spoon from that house. Pretty funny. Isgromor, you know who Isgromor is?
Nope.
Don't know who Isgromor is?
Nope.
I'm gonna tell you. Still lots of potions. So Isgromor, it was this guy that came from Atmora. You know what Atmora is?
Nope.
Atmora is the continent to the north of Tamriel. So Nords hail from Atmora, right? Is the northern part of Tamriel, yes, but up if you live by ship, right? So it's not in the same continent, it's different continent.
So it's above Skyrim.
Above Skyrim, yes.
Okay.
So Isgromor came to colonize Skyrim with from Atmora, right?
Right.
And they had the city of Sartal. That was where he lived. The main quest of the Mages Guild takes place there, a part of it. And after he made his outpost, right, his town, one night the snow elves came and massacred everybody in that city. Everybody, I mean everybody, kids, women, everything. They killed everyone. Only Isgromor and his sons managed to escape. So they went back to Atmora, gathered a bunch of 300 or something companions. That's why they're called the companions. And they came back and just eradicated the whole race of snow elves. Just killed everybody in retaliation. The theory is that the Nords discovered the Eye of Magnus, an artifact with immense power. And they wanted to get it for themselves, you know? So they killed everybody. Isgromor is a hero, a national hero, you know, for Nords.
Why do you always sit?
Because if you click on the table...
It's the same control?
Yes. See? Sit on the bench. So, you know?
So if
I click beside the...
If you misclick.
Yeah, exactly. But I need to make myself little. Okay. So that is who Isgromor is. And in this town... Yeah, there is Isgromor's soup spoon. We're gonna get that at the Museum of Oddities, at the serial killer, you know? He has that there. So that is who Isgromor is. You can actually talk to Isgromor in the game. Did you know that?
No, I didn't know.
You can talk with him in Sovngarde.
Is that the next city? Or the...
I will hit you with something. I will hit you with something. No, Sovngarde is the heaven of Nords. It's like Valhalla, you know?
Ah, I see, I see.
When Nords die in battle and in glorious fights, they go to Sovngarde, to Shore's Midhall. You know who Shore is?
No.
Shore is the highest god in the Northern Pantheon. Is Lorcan, actually. And the myth is that that's why you have to die in battle to go to Sovngarde.
Yeah, I don't care.
Let me tell you. Because he makes an army, man. He builds an army. He builds an army for when the War of Gods will start again. Because at the end of the cycle of the Kalpa, the war will start again and he gathers an army of great
Nords.
What's
Kalpa?
Kalpa is a cycle of the universe.
Ah, I see, I see.
So there are, in this universe, there are lots of cycles.
A kind of Ragnarok?
Yeah, kind of an Ragnarok. So they're preparing for Ragnarok. Actually, that was that is a matter of debate in the community, because Alduin is not a bad character in essence. I mean, he was in this story in Skyrim. The story is that he was corrupted by his own power, you know. But the role of Alduin is to end this Kalpa for the next to get birth, you know, to be born. So this is his job. That's why he was created by Akatosh. To end the universe so the next could take its place. And you as the Dragonborn ended the cycle. So that is pretty bad. Pretty bad for the whole universe dynamic we stole from him.
Ah, I see, I see.
Okay, so let's steal from Hilevi.
So what is going to happen in The Elder Scrolls 6?
The Elder Scrolls 6, I think they won't tackle this idea. So you can cross... Sorry, Hilevi off the list.
Who's this? Hilevi?
Yeah, see how she sleeps with the eyes open?
Yes.
My darling. What do you see there? What do you see there? You see a pot. You see a pot. Why do you sleep with your eyes open, my love? My love, cruel sea.
Your love.
No, not my love. Because she's married with that guy that sleeps over there. See how they sleep. So this spouse sleeps there and the wife sleeps here.
I told you, they don't want to be together.
In case the serial killer comes?
Yes.
I don't know, man. Because the beds are only one person. So I think it's premeditated. Come on, last item. So that's what. In Elder Scrolls 6, I think they will go to High Rock. And I told you, sourcing will be the focus. Not this. I don't think they will toggle the idea anymore about the Dragonborn ending the cycle. And the only the only hint you get about... What we talked about earlier is when Partonax, you know who Partonax is at least, right?
Of course, the Black Dragon, right?
Yeah, the dragon. When Partonax asks you that if you think it's okay to not let Alduin eat this Kalpa for the next one to commence, and you say like that is the next world's problem, not mine, you know, like a true badass, like.
Ah, I see.
Dragonborn, or you can say something else. Like, I don't care, you know, like, or Alduin brought this on himself, but Alduin, yeah, that's the story. He got corrupted by his own power.
Do you think Starfield will launch this year?
I don't know. No, I don't think so. I don't think so. I think the hype train should have already started. See another knapsack, gold necklace, not...
I mean, they still have time.
I don't think so. To start the hype train, no. It should
Do
be.
They really need hype train?
Well, a bit, yeah. Although they're Bethesda, they say.
Yes, but not too much. A few months, maybe.
Yeah, but at least some teasers, some something. I don't know. Let's wait for E3 to see. You know, let's wait for when.
Are they going to E3 this year?
I don't think anybody's going to E3. I think
no, they are going.
They are going.
But I don't know if Microsoft is going. I know Sony is not going. EA. I don't remember. Nintendo is not going. I think Microsoft is going. So they must have something prepared, right?
Yeah, maybe, maybe. But I think all of them just make, just will make their own, you know?
Yes, Sony and Nintendo, yes. But Microsoft is going to E3.
Yeah?
Yeah.
No. So, okay, everything is done here. Let's go and what time is it? It is 4 a.m. We can do the temple and that's that for this day. So we finished the upper quarters of the city. This is where the rich folk live, right? Now we're going to the temple district. But before going to the temple district, I want to show you something interesting. So, Bethesda, in his all-powerful wisdom and Master Todd, made a wall that bleeds. You know? You heard that right. A wall that bleeds. So, in order to get there, we have to go... Where is the wall that bleeds? Where is the wall that bleeds? I think the wall that bleeds is...
Is this the blood thing related that you said at the beginning of the video?
What blood related? Yeah, the blood thing. So, the wall that bleeds is... So, let's find the wall that bleeds. Where is the wall that bleeds?
I don't know.
I don't know. Where is the wall that bleeds? Where are you, wall that bleeds? I think it's in the up, in the backside.
Fake fan.
Nah. You didn't know who Shore is, man. There is a guard here.
I haven't played this game since the 360 era.
Shh. Let me pickpocket the guard. It's another blonde guard. See, he fights with a great sword, not with the regular sword. Okay, shh. Don't disturb him. Okay, and now the last thing, the clothes. Okay, bye-bye, guard.
Can you murder everyone in Skyrim and still finish the game?
You cannot murder, essential characters.
Ah, you cannot?
The closest thing you can do to that is abuse the glitch of alchemy. And just... Here's a lady. Shh. And another guard here. Abuse the skill of alchemy and make potions of paralysis that last for actual years in real life, you know? And just paralyze them.
You're not getting...
Okay, that's the closest right thing you can do, all but right. You cannot murder. You so I'll show you when we enter next the palace. I cannot murder. Turn around. I did it. You cannot murder. Let's say Ulfric. Although I want to so bad. Just go to that motherfucker and kill him. I hate Ulfric, but you cannot do it until the game allows you to do it. You know. He's arrogant. He's so fucking arrogant. Like, he looks... He's like Nazim.
I mean, he's the ruler, right?
And what if he's the ruler? He's egocentric.
He has the army. He has the money.
He's egocentric, right? He's... Where is that wall that bleeds? I don't know. We'll find it. He's egocentric. He's arrogant. I hate him. I hate him so much. That's why I always side with Imperials. Just because I hate Ulfric Stormcloak that much. Just because of that. Temple of Talos. So, we're going to the temple. There are only two couples that sleep together. One we can find in tavern. So only two couples. Right, they sleep together and this is one of them. Nothing worth of steal to steal here. So this is the Temple of Talos. I think it's the only Temple of Talos you can find in... there is one in Markarth. Forget about it. But there has been a murder there. We're gonna go there too. Okay, let's steal all the books and then steal everything from the priests. Okay. So these two sleep together, see? They know what's up. A little bit of Humpty Dumpty, how you call it. Love making in the night. I don't know, man, how you call it. A little bit of love making sessions, you know? See the bucket. The bucket was there. Okay, let's steal the Adar cheese. She likes gourmet food, Jora. You like to spice things up in bed with a little bit of cheese, right?
What are you talking about?
She likes to eat cheese.
In bed?
Yes, while they Humpty Dumpty. So, otherwise, why does he she has cheese? Huh? Why? I understand.
I don't know, maybe a quick snack before bed?
Before bed, before, no, during. During. That is my theory. It's a good theory.
There's no way to prove it.
Well, let's just say I've indulged myself in that kind of behavior. Like you stop a bit, you get a little cheese and go on. It gives you energy, you know? Just a quick snack.
The cheese gives you energy?
Yes.
What kind of cheese?
Cheese. Cheese!
There's different type of cheese.
I don't know, man. I just eat the one that I can get at the shop. I'm not a connoisseur in cheeses. You know? I don't know that many types of cheese. There's a guard there, but he doesn't have a weapon. So we already stole from him, right, guard? Let's see. Yeah, we did. We did.
I know you.
We did steal from him. Oh, yeah. Did you know that you can alter time retroactively in this universe?
Yes, of course. Everyone knows that.
Yeah, of course they do. When Talos ascended, he... what was that word? Altered the geography retroactively, yes. He altered the... Did I steal from you? Yes. He altered the region, the geography of the Imperial region, Cyrodiil, you know? He made it from a jungle to not a jungle. No? Yes.
Very, very clever.
Very clever, yes, he did that. He's Talos Almighty! So, I think it's time for us to hit the... here, what is this? The inn here. Let's go from the entrance. We robbed from you, right? Cross her name, because we robbed from her already.
Who's that?
Ariania. We robbed her. So this is the wife of Urundil, or what was his name, you know? We did that, she's the stable girl. He was a stable boy, she said, see you later, boy, you know? He wasn't good enough for her. It's a parody of Skater Boy. I said stable boy. It's funny. You don't understand humor. Let's steal from her. Okay. I don't know why she sits like that right there. But she doesn't see us because the lighting here is shit. But see, potions. Lots of potions. More potions than in Whiterun. So that would be a great comparison. At the end, after we finish all the cities, we can do that comparison, you know? So Elda Early Dawn, you can cross her off the list. Why is she called Early Dawn? Is my question. I don't know. Early Dawn. Because she wakes up early in the morning. That could be it.
You little thief.
You little thief. Not little. Shouldn't we get some mod for better, whatchamacallit, underpants, you know? Some thongs, you know, some chainmail. Some chainmail underpants, that would be fun. Yeah, there are mods for that, but we should install them, so, you know. Something feisty to see. You can also cross Voltsi Girion. She's a sailor, right? Did you know that? You did not know that. Now you know. The more you know. Okay, let's take everything from her. We took everything from you. This guy is a racist. I hate him. Why do I hate him? Because he's a racist. So we steal everything from him. I know because he goes to the Grey Quarters and just shouts about like, I hate you dark elves and things like that. Okay, let's say Captain Lonely Gale. Why is he called Lonely Gale? Okay, let's make everybody naked. Big orgy at the pub today.
Truest sons and daughters.
Okay, just you, piece of cake, man, you.
We drink to
our youth. Days passing on, coming on. is now nearly done.
Is that the same song that the bard was singing in Wyvern?
Yes, but she sings nearly done, and the bard sang just about done. And I think she sings about Ulfric as a champion, not as a down with Ulfric, you know? There is two variants of the song. See? All hail to Ulfric. So the lyrics are a bit different, but the rhythm is still the same. You know, like... what was it? Maya He song, you know? Maya He. Maya He. No? In every language is a bit different.
You know, no, I didn't
Numa,
hear
Numa,
that.
Numa, Numa song, you know? Numa, Numa song, you know it? Raise a pledge, dar Numa, Numa, yay.
Stop singing, please.
You know the song. There is one in Taiwanese, that, no, in Indonesia, that is the best.
Why
variant.
Do you know all of this?
Because I searched for it online. There is no problem.
The Numa, Numa song.
Numa, Numa song, yeah, from Indonesia. It's called Buka, Buka, An.
Buka, Buka, An.
Yeah, it's a pretty fun song. Pretty, pretty fun song. Okay, Niels, you can cross Niels off the list. He is a woodcutter. He cuts wood during the day. One can say he has the best wood, morning wood here in Windhelm, you know. He chops wood early in the morning. Early in the morning. Okay, both Niels, you have no... What's with his feet? What's with his feet? Ah, he has toes. I thought he did not have toes. I thought he was, you know. But it doesn't look like he has toes. What are these textures, Todd? What are those textures? Okay, let's go to the next room. To the next room. Oh, there was something here. I stole from you, right? You were the Rolf Stonefist. Yes.
Every night,
fuck you, Rolf Stonefist. Okay, close the door. Dresser, boots. We take the bucket. This is a toilet. Told you. Now, it makes a lot of sense. And that's it for this room. See? Few items. So, Niels, you saw him sleeps with her. So this is the only, the second couple that sleeps together in Whiterun.
Susanna
Windhelm.
The Wicked.
Yeah, Susanna the Wicked. She's called the Wicked because she's wicked hot. Wickedly hot.
Wickedly hot.
Yeah, wickedly hot. It's a thing. I did not make it up. It's a thing. Wickedly hot. She is pretty tight. I mean, I think she's thicker than most lady ladies.
Yeah? She's a little thick, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, she's thicker than most ladies. So, yeah, I would bang her. 10 out of 10. Me as a character, not in real life. You know what I mean. Okay, let's take sex. Lives. By her voice, what race do you think the singer is?
I don't know.
Just a guess.
Elf?
Yeah, she's elf. But what kind of elf?
High elf.
Nah, she's dark elf. Haha.
Unlucky.
No, you don't know your lore. But this is the Master Strongbox, you know. And the ledger could be found in the next room when Niels was sleeping. So maybe Niels and Susanna Wicked are the patrons, whatchamacallit, the owners of this fine establishment here. Establishment! So let's... See what I
What's
told
that?
You?
Is that a pizza?
No, it's an apple pie. Apple pies are on the floor everywhere. I don't know why. It's common area here in Windhelm for the apple pies to be on the floor. So if you did not know that, here, a new bit of information. Apple pies, you keep apple pies on the floor.
Probably a bug.
Yeah, most likely. They go to the table, or I don't know what happens.
So they go through the table.
Yeah. But where, there was something here that, where? Salmon. No, I took it. I took everything, right?
I think.
Yeah, but it's, something was here. Something was here. Where was it? Ah, no, the cupboard. I have a high reach. So, oh, Captain, what are you doing in the kitchen? You came for Susanna the Wicked. You're going to do some wickedly actions here. Okay, let's see. So, see, this is the singer. And this is Nilsin, I already pickpocketed, right? Yes. So we Luafin. Okay, 3 items at a time. Okay, and now save.
Nah, she saw me.
Goddamn, lady saw me. You know why dark elves are dark?
No.
Azura cursed them. They were golden before that.
Golden?
Yes, they were the Chimer. But Azura cursed them. She was like, from now on, your skin will be gray as ash and your eyes will be red as fire because you betrayed me. And they were cursed. So that's why Dunmer are Dunmer. They were the Chimer before. That's what they were called. Because Vivek Karmolexia and Sotasil, what's his name, killed Nerevar or some shit like that.
And those were the elves?
Yeah, those all of them were the High Council, the tribe. Oh, come on, he saw me. Were the tribunal of the King Nerevar in Morrowind. And they colluded, killed him. That's what one story relates. And they became gods, living gods. That's why they killed them, because Nerevar did not want to use the heart of Lorcan to become god. And they were like, screw you, and killed him. So they'll risk their lives. They were punished by Azura. They were like, okay, come on, man. What? Why do you enter the room? Come on, mom, I'm playing. Periite is the Edict Prince of Tusks and Disease, Pestilence. Come on, where are you? You know who this guy is? Brunwulf, Free Winter. Leave it there. Okay. You did it, not me. Okay, if you kill, whatchamacallit, Ulfric. This will become the next Jarl. Brunwulf Freewinter, he is an Imperial supporter.
Oh no, you don't!
The last item! Did you cross him off, Brunwulf?
Of course.
Wanna hear, I like it how in Skyrim, you know, they keep the things from real life. If you want to change the sides, you know, like, change the Jarls. The previous Jarl does not die, they just move to another city, you know? So the rich never get killed. It's only the poor folk that get slaughtered in the war, you know?
And where do they move?
They move to another Jarl's court. So let's say the Jarl from Markarth will let them live at the castle, you know, things like that.
Oh, I see.
So the rich, you know, don't die. They don't fight, don't die, and so on. So I stole from you. I stole from you. This is a writer. I'll steal from him.
Adonato. Lutelli.
Yeah, he's a writer. He's an Imperial writer. No. Load Jenny. And I'll talk to him afterwards, because he will give me a book to take to Solitude, and haha, I will not take it. I'll just steal it from him. So, yeah, just a little bit of know-how of the game to make one plus item, you know, in the city. Okay, just a bit, wait for me, yes, done. No, I'm gonna talk to him. What kind of writing you do? Okay, yes. I'll deliver the book for you. But guess what? I will never deliver it. This is mine.
Oh,
you know.
So he just gave it to you.
Yeah, he just gave it to me. But I will not deliver it. I'm just like, psych, joke's on you. There was a broom here. You saw, I came upstairs, right? Those stairs.
Yes.
If I exit that door, where do I exit it? Do I exit on A, balcony, or B, street level?
Street level.
Yeah, you're right. But that was a trick question, because you were expecting it. Otherwise, I wouldn't have asked. It's actually balcony. No, it's street level. Let's take this. He saw me while I was trying to get his boots. I cannot take that armor on him. Sadly. It's too heavy. I'm so sad. You should do an animation of how you undress people, you know? In Skyrim. Okay, so the armor stays on him, but he's barefoot now! Haha! And I stole everything from you, Susanna the Wicked, right? You are wickedly hot. Why don't you laugh? I just did a motorboat, it's called, you know?
When, the motorboat.
Yeah, yeah, when you put your head in somebody's bosom and do the... You know? Motorboating is good. And thick is something of measurement.
Of course.
So you can cross Viola off the list. Cross Viola off the list. Viola Giordano. Okay, so we did...
I mean, she was already crossed.
You crossed her? I did her house.
Yes.
But I did not rob her. I robbed her
I
now.
I see, I see.
I robbed her now, so it's okay. You, guard, do you have a weapon?
Wait, I know you.
No, you don't have weapon. Okay, let's go. So, let's wait for the night to come. I'm gonna go to the market and try to rob Niranye. That guy is Niels. You see? The morning wood chopper. He chops wood in the morning. Early in the morning. I did everybody here. So I did everybody here except for her. I will try my best to do her. Not in the sexual way, but in the steal from her kind of way.
Hands to yourself.
I'm gonna keep my hands. See what she said? Keep your hands to yourself. Wasn't that a sexual joke?
No.
It was. It was. Where? Come on, get hidden. Because I don't know her schedule. I don't know when she sleeps, Niranye. Because I never found her back at home, you know? That's why
Where is her house?
First house in the other district. Come on. Can't I, if I... Ah, like that, see? You just have to go...
Why you?
My little thief.
She saw you.
Yeah, I saw. So, you saw the key she had. That key is the key to the other thieves' guild here in Skyrim. High elf, kind of. Cutthroats. But they are criminal, they kill people. But the Thieves' Guild killed people too, so...
So she's a secret thief?
Yeah, she's a thief. She's and if you... Do all the Radiant quests here in Windhelm, and you regain the city, she will become your fans, you know? For stolen items. So... And she catches you a lot because she's a thief. And I told you, some characters like thieves, guards and such.
Yes. No.
Okay, I took the gold. One item at a time, I guess. So see, the key to the den was there. One item at a time. Let's do all of them. Yes. Okay, we're done. So Niranye is off the list. You can cross her off.
Niranye.
I don't know how you spell that. Okay.
Doesn't matter.
Niels, we did Niels. Niels, just work some wood there, my friend. So, now we're going to her house. This is her house. You asked me where her house is. This is her house. We're just gonna make sure save little. We have the key. So no more lockpicking for us. We go inside the house and steal everything. Let's go. So there's nothing here actually to give her away as a thief. That's strange. Bethesda should have put more clues behind, you know, in the world building. I mean, see, nothing much to make you suspect anything. I mean, I don't know what to say. I would put something. I think there is a sign on her house, but just that. Okay. Steal everything.
I mean, why would you want to give it away that she's a thief?
I mean, not give it away, but just a clue, a hint, you know?
I mean, the sign is the thing.
Yeah, but just another knapsack. Let's see what good loot we have there. Just that. See the shovel, the shovel. The shovel is for burying your own feces.
Yeah.
I think this is how they go to bathroom. Okay, let's take the knapsack. Look, silver amethyst ring. Yeah, vigorous healing. Nah, good enough. Not the best plunder in the world, but good enough. So steal cabbages from her. Oh, lots of cabbages. She likes eating green, you know? Going green. Okay. The cheese. A lot of garlic. We should... you know what series we can make? Do in real life. We cook in real life the recipes from Skyrim, you know?
I mean, people already done that.
Yeah? Yeah,
it's actually... There's an official Skyrim cooking book.
Yes?
Yes.
I did not
know. I don't know how many recipes there are, but...
There are a lot. So there is already...
Yes.
Yeah, Simpsons did it. Simpsons did it, you know? There's the reference. It's, from South Park. So, let's go. They were trying to do... Butters was trying to do something in one episode, and everything he wanted to do, Simpsons did it first, you know? Like, Simpsons always do. Okay, so let's pickpocket this guard. Hello, guard. I will take everything from you. Just sit there and...
By the wood or the yard.
Stop right there.
All right. But you just watch yourself.
Bill. We did it. We did it. We so this is the museum of the Calixto. You know, the serial killer. But first, we robbed the guy that lives here. So we're gonna enter his house. The Free Winter, the Jarl, the future Jarl of the city lives here. He was a hunter, by the way. He was a warrior in his youth. And there is a place we cannot see another hoe. He likes hoes. Yeah, hoes. See, and the shovel to go to the bathroom. A saw there. You saw? A saw. Some fine clothes. Hmm. Should take everything from him. Slaughterfish egg. Let's see. But what? See, so a lot of... I don't know why you cannot take these skulls here, you know? You can take the bow, although... And the skulls you cannot take. Some skulls you can take...
Can't take that one?
No, see? And it moved. I don't know. I don't know the logic behind it. But we got some great armor. Okay. Now we go into his room. A knapsack. Let's see what's here. So, silver ruby ring. So, pretty good. 260 septims. That's not something to throw away, I guess.
Ah. Wait, did that fall?
Yeah. You can do things false with... I don't have the Fuzz Roda, but... Because I did not do anything from the main quest, but... you can, yeah, we can...
You can shout.
Yeah, we can shout things off. So that skull we could take. That was a troll skull. I think a trophy from his youth days. And this is a hoe. And a bucket. And a bow here.
Lots is of... he retired now?
Yes. He looks retired. I mean, he's old. Free Winter, his name. So let's take things from here. This barrel right here. Sack of flour. And see, that would be a good place to place a secret. But no secret.
Can you go up there?
Yeah, but very hard. I tried for half an hour. But there's nothing there, no secret. Hello, guard. So this is where Aretino boy lives. That place there. We're not going to Aretino boys. We're going to Calixto's House of Curiosities. This is the butcher of Windhelm. This is the serial killer that... So let's steal everything from his room. First, a bucket. I told you what they use buckets for. Okay, let's see. The wardrobe is empty. This is another unique item here. Let me show you. Pretty nice. Pretty nice unique item is this. The dancer's flute. Yeah, this is another unique item. But not this. I was referring to this. Isgromor
soup spoon.
And it's a fork.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's strange. It's strange. Don't
they messed it up.
I don't know. I think it's just funny, you know. The chest is empty. It's a funny tidbit. So, plentiful healing, gold ring. Okay. Not. Woodcutter's axe. As you saw, we had two woodcutter's axe until now, and we could not pick them. But this one we can pick. A hoe here. We cannot pick that either. Okay. I was talking about if you want to some Dwemer artifacts. Those are good. We're talking about... And the pitchfork is here. Don't look at me. Pitchfork. Let me just hide. They were talking about the giant's toe. See? We have two giant's toes here. If you want to boost up your money when you start the game, just come here, steal the two giants' toe, and make the potion. You know? Okay, let's see.
Pickpocket!
Jenny. Pretty strange. And the quest with the butcher. Sorry for the sound. Very strange quest, because you can come here, take his diary, but you cannot accuse him until you do other steps, you know? Pretty...
Can you make him confess?
No, I don't think so. Or at least not until the end. You can sell him the amulet you find at the crime scene. So this is the guy you sell the amulet to. So Calixto, I took his key. Let's take everything from him. Hag, raven, feathers, and buko. And everything. Some, there is one thing there. I need to jump and grab. See? It works every time.
Yeah, jump and grab.
Yeah, it's a good method of doing things. See? Okay, let's take everything. There is something. Yeah, there is a frostbite venom right there. Hopefully he will not see me. Some embalming tools. See? So this is the first clue. You get that he is indeed the killer. Let's quick save the game. See if we can steal everything from here. Yes, we can. Nightingales, truth or fiction? Is it truth or is it fiction? Do you know? Nightingales. It's truth. They are the protectors of Nocturnal, the Daedric Prince of...
Is there any inventory limit in Skyrim?
No, just wait. See Butcher's Journal. So you see, Butcher's Journal, we found it. So
very well hidden.
Yeah, but you need to pickpocket this key. And this is the place we cannot reach. I tried for an hour, we cannot go there. So yeah, there are some barrels there, but what can you find in barrels? Just some carrots, some cabbages, red apples, green apples. What can I say? No, there is not no limit. It's just a weight limit.
I see.
But if you use the glitch where you can, let's see what our weight limit is. 500390. That's our weight limit. Name's lot. Lewis. So this is the Aretino's boy house. This is the guy that summons the Dark Brotherhood. You know, we're gonna go there. There is a inconsistency here, right?
Why is that?
I'll show while I enter the house. So, you see the house, yeah?
Yeah.
It's pretty big, right?
Yeah.
So he was rich, right?
Was?
Well, his family.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, he's rich, right? Until now, all of it makes sense. But after his folks died, he was sent to the orphanage, the only orphanage in Skyrim that's in Riften, to be taken care of by what's her name there? And he came here because the headmistress was a really bad person. But if he was so rich that he owned this house, still owns this house, and he has a missive, I'll show you. Let's enter the house. Somebody sees me. And he has, in his home, he even has a letter from Ulfric sending his condolences. So he was really, whatchamacallit.
See, high up in the ladder.
Exactly. He was sent to the orphanage. Here is the letter. I'll show you. See? Letter from the steward. Master, Jarlulf Stoneclaw wishes to express his deepest. So I think this is a little bit of an inconsistency by my logic. So he has money. He had money, but he has money because this is his house. And he was sent to the orphanage. I mean, you could pay for somebody, some dark elf here, you know, take care of him. I don't know. But see, if you do not steal things from this house, you just pick them up. So, I don't know, maybe he lost the house.
Probably he lost
yeah.
it.
Yeah, Todd, please tell us. Please tell us what happened here. Very tired. The pot is okay. Let's see. So he keeps on doing the Black Sacrament over and over again. The Black Sacrament is a ritual in which you invoke the Night Mother. And hire the Dark Brotherhood. See, it involves some skeleton or human heart, some human flesh. See,
Sweet mothers.
Okay, let's. I will talk to him because I want him to stop doing the.
Whose skeleton is that?
I don't know.
Sweet mother.
But, no reaction.
Okay, are you alright? Okay, I know the Dark Brotherhood remains silent. Okay, contract. And I need to kill Grella the Kind. She is the headmistress of the orphanage in Riften. We will kill her when we steal everything from Riften, okay? Just to make this boy happy. Just kill her. I hate that character too. She's really, really
can you
not.
Jump there? Yes.
Yes, we can, but we cannot open this barrel.
So it's empty.
Yeah. Only the light skinned colors you can a barrel you can rob, not the dark skin. Is this the wall I'm talking about? Hit the wall.
Where is it? The bleeding wall.
Yeah. I'm just hitting walls. Bleed, goddammit. Bleed. It's not this. I don't know, maybe.
Maybe they patch it.
Yeah, maybe. Okay. See, we can. Can we go up? I never tried to go that, you know, from the buildings. Let's try be like Tick. You know the Tick, the superhero?
The Tick?
Yeah, the Tick, you know?
That's what's that?
It's a superhero that jumped from building to building. I don't think you can. Bummer. So we did.
Is there an invisible wall?
I think so, yeah. We robbed you, right?
Wait. I know
you. Yeah, we robbed you. You don't have anything in your inventory, although you are fully clothed. Nice work! Okay, so barrels. Let's take everything from this barrel. This barrel. Okay.
Hi, lady. Would you like to buy some flowers?
Please. Sorry, not right now.
Out of my way, kid.
Come on, man. I will adopt her. Sorry. After I steal everything, this is the first child I adopted in Skyrim. Pretty sad story. She's an orphan too. She sells flowers. I'm sorry, Sophie, but I will come for you, my love. Don't worry about it.
Why don't you adopt the rich kid?
Because I don't think you can adopt Aretino. But why would I adopt the rich kid?
Because you get a nice house.
You are such so heartless. Sophie sleeps here. Here is where she sleeps. And you want to adopt the kid?
I mean, why don't you send her to the orphanage?
You cannot. You can just adopt her. And I'm so sad you can only adopt two kids. Otherwise, I would have adopted every last kid in Skyrim.
What are you, Mother Teresa or something like that?
Yes, man. Poor kids. She's sitting here selling flowers all day. You are heartless. Heartless!
Of course.
Yeah, you are heartless. Okay. Okay. So everything has been taken care of. Let's empty these three barrels. Okay, we did that. And now let's go into the Grey Quarters, it's called here, you know. So this is where the Dunmer live. And this is the only one that did not take an arrow to the knee. I think he took a bat to the back or something like that.
A bat to the back?
Yeah, in the war or something like that. So you can cross these two off the list. Mithril, Elani.
Mithril and?
We'll go to him. Just.
Why?
Come on, man. He caught me. I think he's the owner. I think this is the owner of the inn in the lower quarters. Did you know that here? No, don't enter. Dun. So let's pickpocket this guy too. Faril, okay. You little thief. Now you're not so war-stricken. Faril, are you? Now you catch me. Now you come at me. Asshole. So, did you know that the rarest item in all of Skyrim is here. It's here. Right here.
What's the item?
I'll show you.
The soup?
No, not here, but close. This is the rarest item in all of Skyrim. Let's the barrel. And you can find it here. At Sadri's used. Where's? So, it is a circlet called Sadri's circlet that you can buy off of him. Huh? Why is the guard here? I don't know. You can buy off him.
All my good.
What do you got for sale? Let's see. A pearl. If it's here, I'm gonna... It's not here. See? So it's called Sadri's circlet that only has a 2% chance to appear whenever he gets new items. So you need to retry it hundreds of times in order to get. Some said on Reddit that they tried like hours on end, like 10 hours to get that circlet. It's nothing much, it's actually
and
just a
what
circlet.
What do you use it for?
No, it doesn't have any use. It's just a real circlet. Sorry. It's just a simple circlet.
I see.
What is the rarest item you can ever get in Skyrim? I mean, you have the bragging rights afterwards. I don't know to whom. But you have the bragging rights to tell
everyone. Reddit.
Yeah, to Reddit, to show it. Like, I got it. I got it, my friends. You know?
I'm always happy to see a customer.
Okay, let's take everything.
I won't deal in stolen goods. That's trouble I don't need.
We're gonna take everything there is up here. And then we're gonna wait for nightfall and rob the other place. So this is another skill book. This is the third, I think, we found, right?
Second seed. Is that a history book?
I think so, yes. But I don't know what it teaches you. It's a skill book of something. See, lots of potions.
Oh, they found you.
What say in your defense?
Can you pursue him?
No.
Nope.
No, I need to just load game. I don't know where I... Hopefully... Yeah, before I started, so it's okay. It's now in my blood to just go 10 seconds quick save, 10 seconds quick save. I mean, I know how he saw me. I don't know how he's
happy to see a customer.
Okay, I will take everything from here and then quick save again. Yes, so we can do it like that. So, see, lots and lots of potions. I'm really curious about the number of the potions in this city. Do you know there is a mission in which you leave Skyrim in the game?
Of course, everyone knows that.
No, really, did you know?
No, of course not.
Ah, you don't know? It's from the city. From the city.
Ah, you leave the continent?
Yes.
I see.
It's very well hidden, very, very well hidden. I mean, I did not know
and
it.
And where do you go?
You go to the port. Talk to someone that works for the East Empire Company, trade company, and they say they have some problems with bandits. And you go on an island just upshore of Skyrim, you know? You go there, but it's just a dungeon crawl, so no big deal. But still, it's the only quest in which that happens.
Make sure to save before.
Yeah, I'll save because I have to pickpocket him. He cannot see me because I'm behind him, you know? You know? The more you know. Okay, so you can cross him off the list. Revin Sadri. Okay. Boots. And one more item. And we're done. Okay, let's go into his room, pickpocket everything, and not pickpocket, take everything, like a good... See, this is the ledger from the Thieves Guild. Every shop owner has one of these, so you can forge the numbers. Okay. Do a little bit of, whatchamacallit, money laundering or something, you know?
Who?
He saw me, who saw me? Ah, Sadri saw me, but why did he see me? I don't know, he was looking in front. He was looking just up front, and he saw me. Do you know how you stop a troll from regenerating health?
Freeze him?
Fire.
Fire?
Yes, you use fire.
I mean, it makes sense.
Yes, they're very resistant to cold, but they're very weak to fire. So if you want to, when you first go, Hrothgar, you can either run, So that's a possibility, you know, running. I just ran. But if not, you can kill him with the fire. Because if you are low level, he will regenerate health faster than you hit him, you know?
At low level?
At low level, yeah. So he's practically invincible.
I see.
But with a little bit of fire and know-how, the troll will die by the hands of the almighty Dovahkiin. Dovahkiin, no. Okay, did we take everything? Yep, apparently everything. We almost forgot the drum. The drum is the most important thing because it lets you express yourself with music. And music is the soul of life. And can you pour me, please, a glass of juice? Please? Of PepsiCo juice, whatchamacallit. Okay, let's enter the shop. And this is the inn, actually, We entered the whatchamacallit. So we stole from you, right? Yeah, we stole everything from you. We entered the tavern. And let's steal everything from here. Don't look at me! I like that. Quick, steal everything before he looks at me! Now I need to steal this tankard, this bucket. Okay. Can I just sit on the chair? Okay. I need to take this bucket somehow. Like that.
Okay. The whole bucket?
Yeah, I took the bucket. We steal buckets. Let's take... See, lots and lots of potions. No. I think we can add potions to food items here, because there are so many, man. I think they eat health potions for breakfast, you know? Like, what do we eat this morning? A health potion. Give you health. You know? Otherwise, there is no understanding in why there are so many health potions everywhere. So we're gonna do this really slow. Really slow.
Is this like a city for alchemists or something like that?
No. I think it's just because of the war, man. I told you. Probably. Because of the war, because, They need to be prepared. Yeah, lots and lots of potions. So there were 60 in total, you know, in, let's quick save. Can I take the
in White Run?
In White Run, yeah. We'll see how many there are here after we draw the line. You know, like a good technical designer, we draw the line. Like a good architect, you know?
What are you talking about?
Architects draw line.
No one draws the line.
No, they draw lots of lines. When they do buildings, they draw lines.
No.
Yes. What they draw, if not lines. Lines. They draw lines. So... Good architects draw lots of lines. So
if you say so.
We will draw a line just like an architect. It's a good joke, man.
Of course. The Nord women were murdered.
Not sure why. See, they're talking about the serial killer. And we're in a corner, they cannot spot us. Nord mead, flagon, and flagon. Okay, jump. Nothing there. Okay, so we did not pickpocket him, right? You can cross him off the list. Ambaris. No, we did not. Ambaris. Just take everything he has. His clothes. His... Stop right there, thief! But, okay. Quick load fast and let's go back to the job. Vermina is the Daedric Prince of Dreams. She still dreams. See, we cannot steal his broom. That's why I'm sad. Why can't we steal his broom? So there is a bucket here. Here is the toilet, I guess. Let's go upstairs. Here is an Imperial. Is the only place you can get an Imperial... an Imperial outfit here in Windhelm. Is this place. So if you want to start and get an Imperial armor, you find it here, you know? They are traitors, but of course they are traitors because Ulfric is a racist son of a bitch. And I would be a traitor too. I mean, if he wants us dead, I would rebel against him. Just saying. It's common sense. Here is the strongbox. Let's steal from it. 280 gold. Not bad, not bad. And let's go here. Something behind the stairs. Nothing much. Let's go to the upper quarters of the house. Steal everything from here. So let's see. The pot is empty. This is the ledger of the for the fifth guild missions, so you have it here in case you were wondering, but no one is wondering because we have quest markers, and quest markers show where you should go. That's not good quest design. You are sent to this shop here, right? I would put a quest marker to bring you to the shop here, but not in the house. I mean, just let the player search the home for the ledger. You know what I mean?
I mean, it should give you options because some people like it, some people don't.
You have options. You can take it off.
Ah, so I don't understand your complaint.
My complaint is that... What? Where's the shovel? I almost forgot the shovel. Is that they should not give it to you from the start and you should need to activate it if you want it, not the other way around. That's my only complaint. You know what I mean?
Yes, I understand. It's by default activated.
Yeah, by default. That is my complaint.
Yeah, but a lot of people would be annoyed.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. They went for
convenience.
Convenience, yes. Over immersion, let's say. Okay, everything is done here. And we have the last house we need to do. But no, there are two more houses. But for those, we'll wait until the night, because one is an elf from House Hlaalu. Can you say Hlaalu? Hlaalu, is how you call it. And the other is the house over the road. It's a big house, big house. Okay, we can wait for night time. Okay, we're done. Let's quick save and go inside. Hlaalu, you see? This is his name.
No, I haven't seen it.
So you'll see it when I pickpocket him. So this is one of, I think it was a great house of Morrowind, House Hlaalu. I like saying Hlaalu. His descendant is here. There is an inconsistency in Riften, but I'll talk with you when we get there, next episode, about the Dunmer there, that you find out he's from a great mage house, and they say he's the last one, you know, so that survived. But after that, you go to Solstheim, where the Dragonborn DLC takes place, and there is a great mage from that house there.
Maybe they are just lying to you?
Or maybe, I don't know. That was the biggest mage house in Morrowind. I mean, they should know. So that guy there is from Morrowind, and everybody in his family died on a shipwreck, right? And he's like, I want you to find out where I'm from. Who am I? You know, because I don't know. So you go to the shipwreck and you find a diary saying that he's from that great wizard house. Yes. And he's the last one that survived.
Yeah.
But I told you, when you go to Solstheim, you find a wizard, a chief wizard from that family, alive and well there, you know? So maybe and they were great wizards. I mean, the greatest wizards on the continent. They should have known if some of their family survived somewhere, you know? That's the inconsistency. When they did the script for Solstheim, they did not take that into account, you know?
Probably.
Yeah, most likely. So, another knapsack. We're gonna steal. Let's steal everything from the dresser. Knapsack, you see? Let's see what we got. Golden necklace. Bad. Pretty bad. Pretty bad deal. Sometimes you find diamond necklace that is 1500 septims, you know? So, let's pickpocket Mr. Hlaalu here. Okay, you just sleep there.
Why are you?
Come on, man. It's 90% chance. 90% chance.
Is that the maximum amount?
Yep, that's the maximum amount. And that's why the pickpocket while sleeping perk is just irrelevant. It's like when you max the level, the pickpocket level, it's 90% for everything, even if they are awake.
Oh, I see.
And there is a perk that makes pickpocketing easier while victims sleep. And that becomes utterly useless. So nice game design there, nice game design. They should make like 100% while they sleep.
Sleeping.
Yeah. That should be the thing. Otherwise, the skill is useless. It's... regardless. So let's go to Windhelm. This is the... almost the last house. We have one more house and then we're done! With the houses. But not done in total.
What's left?
The port.
The port and...
and the big house on the hill, you know, the...
the Jarl's?
The Jarl's house, yes. And she just got home, so let's wait for another hour. Okay, we did Atheron Residence. We had the key for it, because we stole from some Atherons before. Okay, so let's do it. So here we have the dog meat, you know. These folks are poor, so see, this is the dog meat. They don't like us at all, I mean... even the dog meat is considered stolen, and it has a value of 2 septims.
In Fallout, the name of the dog is dog meat.
The name of the dog?
Yeah, dog meat.
You named him dog meat or?
No, he's by default.
By default dog meat?
Yeah. I don't remember if you can name him or not.
I would name him Jiminy Billy Bob. That's a good name for a dog.
Well, his name is dog meat.
Yeah, got it. Don't patronize me. Don't patronize me. You see another knapsack here. Let's see.
You can't change his name. I remember now.
You can. Cannot. Can't with a T.
Because there's voice lines.
I understand. And they go like... if I would make a game and I would put the robot voice from Google, you know? To say the character's name every time.
Yeah, sure. That's very immersive.
Immersive, yeah. But not... Don't sit... that would be fun, you have to admit it. I mean, so go up like that. Okay, and now make yourself little, sneak and steal everything. See another potion here. Everywhere potions. Everyone has some. I stole from you. See, we stole from him. This is the elf with the nice hairdo. Remember him from the marketplace? No, we go upstairs now. We steal from all the house Atherion or what their name is. Up the stairs we go. Dresser. Find boots. Oh, they have a very nice outfits in here. So there is a broom in a bucket. So I reckon they don't use that for toilet, hopefully. See, another potion. Lots of potions here. In contrast to White Run. No pie on the ground, so we have always have to look on the ground for apple pies. Some books, large sack with apples. Okay, let's go to this. Let's start with this part of the house. What woodcutter's axe? Okay, let's go inside. We save the game. Let's see. So Baron Zaya. It's not uncommon for dark elves to read about Beren Zaya because Beren Zaya was a dark elf herself. You know, I understand. She has a pretty, see? 2 books on Beren Zaya on this house. She has a little bit of a curious history. We should make a lore video on that. We shouldn't because we don't do lore videos, but her life is pretty interesting. That's why everybody is... okay, let's save it. That's why everybody is obsessed about her.
Is she some kind of god or something?
No, she's a queen. She's just a queen. Yeah, from Morrowind that was exiled to Daggerfall, I think. Or some shit like that, you know?
Why you?
Yes, me. She works for some family in the port, this woman. Okay, so you can cross her off the list. No, you don't. As soon as we manage to steal everything, because apparently she's sleeping like a bunny, you know? Every sound, everything just wakes her up. Okay, let's go to the other side. Maybe this side was the problem. Okay, I took it. And now it's done. Okay. Bye-bye, my lady. Big shield on the wall. And there is one left, one room left. We took everything from this room, I think. Yes, everything is empty. So this room is the last one. And we done it. We done it, boys. We done it.
So we still have...
Yeah, we
a few
need
a place to go.
Yeah, I know. It will take. And the Jarl's house is. It's
big?
Yeah.
It's bigger than White Run?
Yes, I think so too. I think it's bigger than the White Runs. So it would take 40 minutes or something?
40 minutes?
Yes. Well, it has the dungeon, right?
I see.
He has the barracks, are there? You know, remember? White Run had barracks?
Yes,
and the Jarl's. No, I'm sorry. Well, one pair of clothes is not that much. We already stole from that guy, you know? And I left him naked again, but... Pick someone's pocket by activating them while sneaking.
Are you playing as a Khajiit?
No. I'm an Imperial, because Imperial get more money. But this is... You have a torch! So I did not steal from you. No more torch for you. Okay, we're going slow, you know? Just ease it in. I find that pretty strange.
What?
That you can open their inventories even if they see you, and that's not a crime, you know? It's a crime only if you steal from them. So you can look into their pockets, you know?
Yeah, that's pretty strange.
Yeah, look into their pockets, see what they have, and then...
That's an oversight, pretty much.
No, because the hint previously just said that. So it's not an oversight.
Ah.
They did it on purpose.
Ah, yes. So it's a feature.
It's a feature. It's a pretty bad feature, in my opinion, but a feature nonetheless. So where are we going? We're going to the... there is a house here where all the Argonian workers... reside, and during the day they're out and about in the river, so we need to, you know, make them naked in the night, not during the day. We have to take all the salmon here. This is not stealing, but still, we're gonna take everything. That's the whole purpose of the challenge. Okay, someone on Reddit, I posted some graphs, you know, and he was like, so now everybody's dying of starvation, right?
Pretty much.
And I was like, yeah. And he was like, you asshole. Well, it's for the purpose of science. It's for the purpose of science. Tanning rack. No, don't use that. After we do this, we should do the White Run challenge, you know?
The level one challenge?
Yeah, level one, enter the city, 10 lockpicks. And you need to make... the most amount of money, you know? That would be a great challenge. Because the level of RNG in White Run, I told you, or what it's called, is very low. So you need to have a lot of know-how to know how to make money. This is, I think, Argonian Assemblage, yes. So this is the first place we go.
You have 23 lockpicks.
Yeah, but I have the skeleton key.
And?
The skeleton key is an unbreakable lockpick.
Ah, I see.
So I won't lose any lockpicks. Lockpicking trait skill book, you know? It's the one of the most useless skill trees in the game. I mean, it makes... after you surpassed a level, you know...
Yes.
It makes picking locks of that level easier. Why would you want picking locks of that level easier when you have already surpassed that level of lock picking?
Yeah, it doesn't make sense.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense at all. I mean, it's just useless. Useless. And only at level 100 you can make an unbreakable lock pick. You know? Yeah. I mean, why would you make an unbreakable lock pick in the moment you reach level 1000? 100, because by that time all the lockpicks are pretty easy to pick. See another skill book. The thief is here. But it doesn't make any sense, you know? That's what I'm saying.
I suppose.
Okay, let's scout many marshes. Scouts many marshes. So these guys are named as the native Indians, you know? Okay, let's quick save. And two more items. Okay, and two more Argonians, and then, sure, I don't know her name. So, did you cross them off? Netrenaza, scouts, many marshes, and you haven't, no. But I
haven't been writing anything on the list for a while now.
Don't worry about it, because I know all the characters, I know all the NPCs in Windhelm, so we basically did all of them, almost. Not the ones that we did not reach yet, but almost all of them. More sec. Okay, the dresser is empty, and this is the last Argonian. Stands in shallows, and of course he caught me. Of course he caught me. Mr. Stands in shallows. Okay, come on, come on, come on. You're done. So why was I playing as an Imperial? Because Imperial had the perk to where you find money, you find more money, you know? See? See, 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 see. I wasn't talking bullshit. Pies.
Yeah, that's a bug.
Are on the floor. So, knapsack, another knapsack. Silver emerald necklace. This is some good loot. Really good loot. 800 septims. So,
did
this
you
is
took
the reason.
Everything?
What?
Did you took everything?
Not yet. From the knapsack?
Yeah.
Yeah, I pressed square.
Square.
I pressed square and everything has been taken. So let's see here. There is a potion here. I took it, I think. Or there wasn't any potions here. Okay, let's take everything before they wake up. Before they wake up. Three potatoes! Three, the number. Oh, firewood. We almost forgot the firewood, man. Okay, let's see. So, yeah, this end table is empty. This end table is not empty. This end table is not empty also. And Nord Mid. Let's take everything. And that's that. We finished it. We finished this house. Okay, moving forward. Everything has been taken care of. There is a shovel. So every city in Skyrim has some problem, you know? I think Whiterun is pretty much the best city you should live in. So you have the everything here. But Markarth has the problem of the Forsworn. There is a militia group, rebel group, that keeps on killing them.
You have committed crimes against
them. Right.
Just
turn around. Shh, try to get anything. And pray to God.
We got you.
At the last one. So, Markarth has the problem of the Forsworn, where they kill you, you know. Riften has a problem of corruption, where everybody's corrupt. Even the city guards, when you first go to Riften, ask for a bribe to let you in, you know.
Have to bribe them to let you in.
Yeah, and unless you have the unless you have a big speech check, you will. They won't let you in. You have to pay it. What towns? Here is racism, right? All of them are racist. I mean, all of them are racist. And there is another city. Is there? Solitude. Solitude is the capital. So I guess Solitude, yeah. Solitude and Whiterun are the best cities to live in. Solitude will be our crown achievement, Danny. That's a big ass city. That is a big ass city, Solitude. So that will be our last city. Until then, we go for the. And we don't do the small settlements like Falkreath or. They are really small. They're like village, you know, three houses.
They are not important.
Yeah. So there are five major cities.
I see.
Whiterun, right, we did it. Windhelm, we do it now. Maybe we can do Winterhold, I guess. Because Winterhold is the head of the Mage's Guild. So they should have some good loot there.
We have to do it.
But yeah, but the city itself is three houses, you know?
That it doesn't make too much sense.
And so, see, the barrels here are stolen goods. The barrels in the city are not stolen goods. And this is strange.
Maybe just for the statistics.
I would do, but at last. Almost the last. Solitude is the last, you know?
I see.
Maybe I do it once off the camera, see how much loot there is, and if there's enough loot, we will do it on camera, you know? Because I found out it's better to do it first time, to do it several times, not several, couple of times, so you know everything. So let's see, Windhelm Guard, I think this is the... Skyrim and her people.
What say you in your defense?
I am the Dragonborn.
All right. Turn around now. Yourself.
Please turn around now, because you're not next welcome anymore.
So
okay, let's go. East Empire Company. We need to go there. Okay, let's go to the East Empire Company. So this is where you get the mission. This is where it's hidden, man. Nobody comes to the port, and this is where you get the mission to leave the island, you know? To leave Tamriel to go to the island with the bandits. Like, come on, man. It's a very important mission because it's the only one in which you leave Tamriel. Apart from, of course, the DLC in the vanilla game. But really, he did this well. Was that a gold coin? No gold coin there. So, empty. Everything is empty here. Okay. And there is this guy.
Who's this?
Ortus Endario. Yeah, he's just some guy that works here. And you see how the office here is so empty because I told you the bandits just steal everything. Nothing is getting to port. So that is why this is in shambles.
Just poor
in
guy. Shambles.
What?
Poor guy.
Yeah, but after you do the mission, they will not refurbish it. So, yeah, that's an overlook, you know?
Wait.
Mm-hmm.
Clan Shatter-Shield office. Okay, let's do this. We stole the key from that wood elf that works here. Not many items here. But we need to take all of them in order to be, you know, thorough. But... I really was hoping that in the port, first time I did it, I really was hoping that in the port you would find lots of items, you know, it's a port. But nah. In solitude will be fun. Because there is an underground cave, full to the brim with items. Like everything, clothes, everything. Solitude will be, I think, it has the riches of all other cities combined.
That is the capital, so...
Yeah, so it is the capital. Well, Windhelm was the capital long ago. Then Winterhold was the capital. But Winterhold collapsed, you know. And now Solitude is the capital, yes.
I see.
So let's see. Nothing more here, see? So this is... I mean, let me open the chest, see what's inside. Maybe there is treasure inside. No, they don't. Okay, last thing we need to do in the port before leaving is the warehouse of the port, okay, and the sailors. The sailors will be pretty difficult to pickpocket, because they spot you.
Gort
is done. Okay, so first sailor is done. Now let's go to other sailors. We go right or we go left? We go right or we go left?
Let's go left.
Yeah, left. You always go left.
Mercy.
I think one crew here takes you to Solstheim, you know? You know what happened in Solstheim?
What happened?
A great hunt during Morrowind, the era. So Hersin, the god of the hunt, the Daedric god of the hunt, organized the great hunt there. That means lots of hunters and lots of, you know, a big hunt there. He's the father of werewolves, werebears, werecrocodiles, weresharks, or were what you think can you think about, you know? There are lots of were things in here. Kiar.
Wait.
Surprisingly,
he why was he screaming?
I don't know, but
he's the first one that
screamed and ran.
Yeah,
there is the priest in Whiterun, you know, the Talos.
Yes,
and
that
the beggars.
One too.
The beggars do the same. They run from you. They don't attack. Not all of them.
I cannot
best you. See, he's the only smart one, I guess. The only smart one, because everybody else is like, "Oh, you stole from me, Dragonborn, legendary killer of dragons. I will kill you with his knife, butter knife." And I'm like, come on, man. I can Fuzroda you after all, you know? Fuzroda! Rabbit Hutch.
You don't have the shout.
Yeah, in theory. Just saying, I just look badly at you and you die, you know? This is the level of my strength. And you try to...
Never much cared for Windhelm.
And you try to kill me. Okay, still...
He got you.
He got me, but that doesn't matter. He only has one item to steal, so I'll take it. I'll take that too. And that is this and the warehouse, right? And that is that. Then we go to the Jarl's quarters and we finish it. Yes, we finish it. Kill dagger. Okay. Let's do it like this. Okay. And then let's try it fast. We did not. Could not do it. Okay. I encountered, last time I did it, I encountered a bug here. I also stole his hammer from his hand and he was just, hammering in air without anything in hand. And it looked pretty funny. Okay, now. Khajiitar fell and resonated him to elsewhere.
Third one is the charm.
No, just go steady. Okay, so. Salt Sage. He's a Salt Sage. Now he's the last one. Come on. He looks at me, I think. Okay, so graph. Gold and dagger. Okay, not so bad. Quick save, but we have fish barrel here. So let's take everything from fish barrel. Fish barrel here. Hopefully we can... No, not Solgraf, but a fish barrel. Yes! Okay, so everything finished. So, question. Do we jump in the water and take fishes? There are no fishes.
There are no fishes here.
Yeah, there are no fish. There is no fish, so we good. At least we tried. This is the problem with Skyrim. The rivers are too small, too shallow. I mean, lore-wise, they should be able to support ships, but this is not able to support ships, just saying. It's okay, so this is the warehouse. Just to make myself small and just start robbing.
Detected.
Yeah, I saw. It's the naked guard. There's a naked guard up here. Where are you? You see? My love.
Wait,
I know you. I know you know me. This is what they say to you if they don't know you. So, let's say if you have Azura Star, you know? They say, I see you have Azura Star. If you are the Thieves Guild Chief, you say, I see you are a good thief, you know? Things like that. But if they don't know you, they say, wait, I know you. I find it pretty ironic. They don't have anything to say, they say that. Because they don't know you. Okay. So let's get everything from the barrels. Okay, so we're done here with the barrels. Every barrel is empty and we go into the warehouse. Why is it open? Is this open non-stop?
Because daytime.
Okay, sit on in the chair. Just sit there. Okay, let's take, there was some gold here. Aha. Okay, let's go here. Filter of strength. No, well, that was a very expensive potion. So good find there. Okay, let's see. So Let's try here. Nothing. Pitchfork. That is good when you kill Frankenstein, vampires and such, you know. Knapsack. Let's see. Silver emerald necklace. Not bad. Absolutely not bad. Flute. We stole the flute. Absolutely nothing. Come on, man. Why would any player have the interest to come and explore if you don't leave anything for them to find? Well,
the loot.
What loot? What loot? There is none.
The carrot.
The cabbage.
Cabbage.
Yeah.
Sack of flour.
Carrots. Yeah. For this, yes. No, there is... I mean, just hide something. Put something worth...
I mean, what do you expect to find here?
A sword. I know. A unique sword. Not here, but in places like this. Before doing this challenge, I never entered the warehouse. Why would I come here? There's no quest marker. There's no one here. There is nothing to do here. So, no exploration required. Okay, so, this is done. We done everything, now it's time for the real thing, the big thing, the biggest thing. Ulfric Stormcloak himself. Fuck him, I hate him. I really hate that guy. You'll see how he sits in his throne, like all high and mighty.
I mean, he's the king of the city. Well, the ruler.
Yeah, everybody sits in the throne like that, every jarl, but his throne is... placed in an upward position, you know, more higher ground. He has the higher ground, like in Star Wars. You know, Anakin, stop it, I have the higher ground, you know.
You got a nickname for anyone who trifles with us guards here in Windhelm. Suicide.
Let me just, like that, okay. Now, let's pickpocket this nice lady guard because she has a weapon. That means we did not rob her. I like her hair. You sassy old dudette, you! Okay, 3 more items. See, she fights with a battle axe.
You by order of she caught you.
I don't care, because I can persuade her. All right, but you just watch now turn around, let me steal the last thing on you.
Is she blind?
I don't know, we'll see after that. And you disrespect me. Okay, turn around. Okay, let's see. Are you blind, my love? Think about it. No, she's just hot! Tum-tum-ts. Okay, we enter the palace of the kings. And start the pillaging here. Okay, make ourselves small. Okay, and steal from the guards.
I know you.
You don't know me. Okay. First things first, let's empty the pockets of the elite guards, right? And then we move on. Okay, you are done. Let's go to the other bloke here. See, he has a mace. He has a mace, because you asked me about maces.
Yeah.
So everybody has a different weapon, just, you know. I'm curious, I think...
You have committed crimes against Skyrim.
Yes, I did not commit...
What's in your defense?
I did not commit against Skyrim and the people. I committed against you, my friend. Okay, turn around. Okay, let's try everything now. Sometimes it worked.
You have committed crimes against...
No, it did not work this time. Jenny, my love, come on. You can do it. You can do it all night long. You know, from Don't Be a Menace. No, it's from Adam Sandler movies. You can do it!
Think you can my order of the yard.
Stop right there! Persuade.
Alright, but you just watch yourself.
I'll watch myself. Come on, you can do it! Yes! So they go talk about war. Okay, that is good. I stole everything from there, let's see. This is the upper quarters, yes, upstairs. This is the prison, I guess. Barracks, yes. And let's steal everything from the table at first.
harder not seeing you.
I don't know, man. I don't know. It's Bethesda logic. Even the lighting is
just on top of you.
Yeah. I don't know.
You are in the spotlight pretty much.
Yeah, ask Mr. Todd. We're ready when you are. Don't sit at the table. Come on, man. Come on. Okay. That is the dude. I'll show you after I finish stealing everything. So now they see me. Who sees me? This is the dude that you can accuse of being the murderer.
I see.
And he will go to prison. Okay, he goes upstairs, I think, yes.
Can you choose what happens to him?
No, he just goes to prison.
I see.
If you, because he's a strange fellow, you know, and Nords don't like mages, so.
Tell me, Gottmar, why do you fight for me?
I'd follow you into the depths.
He's a necromancer. Surely he did murder the ladies, you know. Okay, let's pickpocket the steward.
Not for me.
Okay, we good now. Okay. Two at a time, steady, easy in. Okay, two more items, and we're done. Okay, now we're going, here is the kitchen. And I don't know why, but the mage sleeps here. So this is where the mage sleeps.
Maybe he's not the mage, maybe he's the cook.
Nah, he's a mage, man. He is the court mage of Ulfric.
And a cook,
yeah. He likes to cook in his spare time. Okay, let's steal everything from... We will make, after this, we can make a series of who's the richest Jarl, I told you.
Probably the one from Solitude?
You should think so, but I don't know. The guy in Whiterun had some riches, and I think in Riften could be a good contender. You know? With the corruption and everything, they have a lot of riches. They are a rich city. We'll see.
Makes sense.
That's why you will be high king.
As I remember, their keep is just full of items to be stolen. Okay, let's steal everything from the table. And look at it, look at this. I mean, this seems poorer than Whiterun. There was a pheasant. Okay, take everything. The baskets. Don't forget the baskets. And just jump on the table and take the rabbit, frost Miriam. What we have here? Garlic pheasant and so. Okay, we're done here. No, we're not done. What did I spot with my little eye? The frost Miriams. Okay, everything here else has been taken care of. Okay, so the kitchen is done. We have the bucket left, just the bucket, and now we move upstairs. We go take Ulfric, the man, the one, the only asshole, and then we go to the quarters, the barracks and such, and everything. Look how he sits there. Look, just look.
Like a true boss.
Don't make me swear. He has the steel axe of cowardice. Do you think, he's a coward. He's a coward. Okay, let's go here. This is his general. Okay, let's rob his generals. Stone Fist. So let's just save the game. And rob him. Okay, let's steal his sword from under his hand. He is a tankard of beer. See, they're just drunks.
You have committed crimes against Skyrim and her people. What say you in your defense?
Persuade.
All right.
Thrice pierce. So he was wounded three times! Okay, let's go easy. In case he sees me again. I'm curious the amount of arrows. How much they differ. How many arrows do these people have? In comparison to Whiterun. Okay, let's take his sword. I think we can... Okay, we can take some things from him. Okay. Now we need to reload, because we already persuaded him. That is bad. You know how you make a shop owner renew his wares? Update his wares for you. You punch him, then reload the save. Then his wares will be all brand new, you know?
So it's a bug.
It's a feature.
It's a feature.
It is a feature, let's say. So, you know, when you come back from pillaging, you know?
Yes.
From dungeoning, whatchamacallit, and you want to sell your plunder. Well, Skyrim has limited amount, merchants have limited amount of gold, you know?
Yes.
So you sell everything, you save, you punch him, you reload, and he has money again.
Can you do the same if 24 hour passes?
I don't know at the exact time, but why would you wait for 24 hours when you just punch him and reload the game? So I went there. Palace of the King. This to connect. So we do the barracks first. Let's do the barracks first. Let's make ourselves little and enter the barracks. We will rock you. We will steal everything from them. Okay, let's go upstairs. So the dungeons are upstairs, apparently. Oh, can we be here? Yeah, I think we can. So don't worry.
Wait, I know you.
Oh, yeah, they just know. Oh, looky here. Man, we were talking to your little guards. Look at here. 10,000 guards. So they're all sleeping, apparently. So that's the thingy. Okay, just wait for me, my love.
Easy money for us.
Yeah. Skyrim and her people. What say you, Nadia?
All right.
You are tight, my lady guard friend. Let's go, everything.
You have committed crime.
Now we reload.
She doesn't like you.
Well, yet. But when everybody's cold and don't have any clothes, and only I have the clothes, she will come for me. She will say, please, give me clothes.
And she will kill you.
No, I will.
And then she will rob you.
I will become her boyfriend. Girlfriend.
Her boyfriend. Are you playing a girl?
Yeah, girlfriend. Then. Skyrim and her people. What say in your defense? Please be my wife. But you just watch yourself. All right. See.
I might not be so lenient.
Okay, girl. Just turn around now. Let me steal everything. Come on, last thing. The last thing I. This. Will take a while. Have you saw how many guards they were sleeping there? Like 1 jillion. Okay, follow her. Go.
By order of the Jarl,
okay, only two items right. Left. Come on, I can do this. I can yourself. Do this. Jenny.
Might not be so lenient.
No. Only two things. The sword. Oh, we did it. Look at those guards sleeping.
I mean, it should be pretty easy. They are sleeping, right?
Yeah, but it's 90%.
90% chance.
Yes. Let me just. Apparently, they see me. Who sees me? The lady.
The lady.
Let me just quick save it pretty often. So. Doesn't have. What? Did I steal from you? Yeah, I stole from you. Let's see this guy. I stole from you also. Okay. And now this. Everybody sees me. Everybody sees me. Come on, like that. Okay. Steal. There should be a skill book here. If I was a game designer, I would put a skill book here. Okay, let's see the chest. This is where your items. Would go. Okay. Don't stop me now. I'm having such a good time. I'm having a ball. Okay. Nothing there. A bucket. Knapsack. Let's see. Gold diamond ring. Now looky here. 900 gold. See? This is where we'll get the money.
I know you.
In a sec. Here. Salt pile. Okay. Let's see. You don't have anything equipped. Ah, you have only your uniform. What about you? What you have nothing on you. Now that is better. Okay, let's see. Windhelm guard. I stole from you earlier. So everybody's sleeping. I stole from you earlier. Okay. So we good. I think we need to enter this sneakily, because here I think there is the jail. The jail. See a hawk. Wah!
Everything all right?
That was a hawk. Okay.
That doesn't look like a hawk.
By order of the Yarl, stop right there.
Why do you have different? So here is a unique. See?
Right, he's the
jailer.
Yes.
Here is a unique uniform for Windhelm guard. Good to know. So the jailer in Windhelm has a different uniform. Let's see. Run! Catch him, catch him, catch him before he goes on the wall.
Too late. Wait.
Well, that was nice.
Yeah, that was pretty lucky.
Yeah, that was nice. I was like, all or nothing. So this is the jail, right? Okay. Oh, you, what? What is happening here? So they have torture chambers and such. See, I told you Ulfric is an asshole. I think he comes here and watches as people get tortured.
What people? There's nobody here. Well, only the guard.
When they kill them and they throw them in the river. Lotus extract. What was that? Something strange was in the lotus extract. Ingredients. You saw lotus extract, right?
Yes.
So that is the unique item. Lotus. No. There was... I don't know. We'll see it when...
At the end.
Yeah, exactly. Wine. Okay, there's a guard there. And an empty guard. Naked guard right behind. So, jail doors. Nothing to steal inside. Absolutely nothing. But this is a good place to actually to make your lockpicking skill, you know? To make it greater. Two expert door, one adept and one master. Pretty nice to level up. Okay, let's see what else there is here. There is some skeleton remains. See? That guy. That poor bastard.
Okay. The wall felt on him.
Yeah, for sure. Let's take everything.
By order of the Jarl,
stop right there.
All right, but you just watch yourself.
Let's try going for everything, but par chance. We did it!
Next time, I might not be so lenient.
Look at me. You are nice. So we took everything from the jail, from the barracks. Okay, so we robbed every white run guard, Windhelm guard. Now, the only place left for us is the upstairs. There we will find some guards, I guess. So, some guards still, and the undying bloke. I robbed you, right? Yeah, I robbed you, all right, okay. Nobody's here, okay, let's go. No. Okay, I think here we need to make ourselves little.
Who's this? Not a thief trying to rob Sifnar.
Yeah, Sifnar Iron Kettle. This is the cook, see?
I see.
Okay, so let's take it. His name is Iron Kettle, so guess, yeah, he's the cook. Now he naked cook. Let's go upstairs, see what's what. There's a guard here. Let's look right, look left, and we can only go this place. So this guard is not robbed yet. Let's see. Don't push our luck.
By order of the yard,
stop right there.
All right.
Just watch yourself. Okay, two more items. Come on, you can do it. Yes, guard. So we have three doors, three of them.
He was pretty fit. Look at that.
Yeah.
Back.
Yeah, everybody's fit. I mean, not all of them, but most Nords are like, yeah. They like pumping irons every time. Was this a skill book? Yes. Look, a skill book. So here is a place for another skill book. Good to know. I'm curious how many skill books there are. There were 13 last. So we'll see here. Okay, sack. There's a sack here still. Sack. Oh, what? No, nothing. They're done. Empty. The cat. Who sees me? I just closed the door. You go. I just tilting. Okay. One green apple, one red apple. Kettle. I can take this kettle. You cannot take the big kettles, but the little kettles, yes, you can. Isgromor's soup. Is it a miscellaneous item or a weapon? Yes, a miscellaneous item. Let's see.
Can you finish Skyrim with only a soup?
A soup fork? A soup? Yeah, there is only, it is already made that. There is a
with
fork.
A spoon?
There is a fork that you can equip as a weapon.
And a spoon?
A spoon, I don't think there is a spoon that you can equip as a weapon. This is the same thing. What you do, you enchant it like God. And every time you hit it, you hit with it, it's like a nuclear missile hitting somebody, you know?
Ah, I see.
So this is the way you do it, yeah. Pretty fun though. You with the spoon just going killing everybody. Okay, so everything has been taken care of in this room. I don't know what is the purpose of this room. Okay, we go into the other room. I think this is where the generals sleep or something. Could be, because there are two generals, two beds. Pretty poor compared to... Nothing here. Absolutely nothing here. Compared to Whiterun. In Whiterun, the protector of the Jarl had lots of stuff. Lots and lots of stuff. But here, nothing. Absolutely nothing. So Windhelm is dirt poor. So we have here one room and the other one room. Okay. Let's see. Go.
By order of the Jarl,
stop right there.
All right, but you just watch yourself.
Okay, next let's time, save it because I have only two more items. Okay, thank you, my ladies. Let's see what's here. Close the door behind us. We have four beds. I don't know who sleeps here. Really, I don't know who sleeps here. Shoes, some clothes iron. And they're dirt poor, man. Windhelm, just mark my words, Windhelm is dirt poor. We shouldn't have taken the knapsacks, man. That was the error, because without the knapsacks, this city would have been oh so poor. Just close the door. Some money on the table. I think she will enter the room in 3, 2, 1. Enter the room. No, she did not enter. I tried. That would have been a moment, right? Let's see. Bread. Wardrobe. Let's see. Hat. Just nothing. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Oh, I feel bad for the people living here, man. Just, they have dirt poor. Okay, now she comes. I think she was just walking on in the door. Okay, so this we did, right? Yeah, this we did. There was nothing here.
Yes, this room.
Yeah, and we have only the wizard's room left. So this is the wizard room. Told you about him. But he sees us. Okay. Let's do it slow and steady, like that. Bed. See, he has a bed. You see?
The wizard?
Yeah.
Of course.
And he sleeps in the kitchen. You saw two giant toes. Okay, so he sleeps in the kitchen.
I don't know.
Yeah, me neither. He saw me.
Maybe he likes the smell.
Maybe, but... Nah, he caught me. One gold. One for one gold, they would have taken me to prison and take all my items. All my stolen items. What I was saying? Yeah, two giant fingers here. Toes here. So, Yeah, four giant toes in total. So that's... Yeah, that's a lot of money. That's a lot of money. If you make the potions, those are a lot of money.
What's the value of one? Like
that. One potion like that?
No, one giant toe.
The value of a giant toe is pretty low, but the potion you make with it is...
I see.
Is off the rail. Okay, so let's steal everything from him. Deft hands. Pickpocket success 20% better. What do you do with that ring? What's your name? He saw me. He caught me. Okay. See, his name is the Unliving. So, yeah. People consider him a necromancer of sorts or something. Okay. So, we're done with him. Let's steal the goblets right in front of him, like that. Everything done. The bucket. Crypt cluster. So you need, I told you, for the potion you need crypt cluster, wheat, that is pretty easy to find in any farm. And...
Scroll Blizzard, Harmony.
That is expensive, yes. And giant toe. So you have two of the ingredients in the same room. So this is...
Are those books, the scrolls?
Yes, they
count as
the
book.
Yeah. Ah, I got the mission for the Dwemer machination, what you call them. Okay, so everything is done in this room, right? No, some embalming tool. Okay. Okay, everything is done here. Ah, everything is done here. Okay, let's go. And an unusual gem for those that search for the Berenzaas thing. So, we got here, we got everything, right?
Right.
Okay, there is one more room we did not make. And we're going there, and that's that. It's a wrap. It is a wrap. Go to the Palace of the Kings. And there was... I thought they were connected, but apparently they're not.
Which one is the Yar's room?
So this... Yeah, we entered this, right?
Yes.
And it's called... What's the name? Palace of the King upstairs, right? And this place... It's called... Palace of the Kings upstairs.
And they are not connected.
Did we miss something?
Maybe.
Map? No, it's a different map. It's a different region. But they're called the same. Come on, Bethesda. Focus!
Letting us down like this.
Yeah, just name your... Oh. Yeah, I think this is where the Yar lives. Okay, doesn't matter, we're gonna steal from them. Come on, get lucky!
Easy money.
Took everything. Close the door. Let's see if we have some riches here. None so this is so pointless, like robbing Windhelm is so pointless. Well, if you're max level with the knapsacks, it has some value, but... By God, this city is worthless. It's absolutely worthless. Cheap dirt. Are two guards sleeping here? We have a double bed. Strange. Let's see. Absolutely nothing, man. Absolutely nothing.
Is this a guard's room?
I think so, yes. I think so.
I'm probably not, right?
But whom? Whom sleeps here?
I don't know, but it doesn't make sense to be the guards room.
I don't know, but...
They should sleep in the barracks.
Right? I think the if the Jarls from other region move here, I think this would become...
Maybe some elite guards, but other than that...
I don't know, man.
It makes sense for them to not have so many things.
Yeah, but they don't have anything, like anything, some apples, that's it, the whole room. I mean, in Whiterun, it was full of books, of everything. Here is, there's nothing, man, nothing. So this it is, I cannot stress this enough. Did I do the other room? Yeah, I did the other room. No, I did not do it. But what's the point? What is the point of everything? Easy.
Yeah, they don't care anymore, pretty much.
What you say?
They don't care anymore.
Ah, yeah.
The guards.
They're like,
yeah, just take everything from me and leave me alone. You've been doing this for what? 3 hours?
Yeah, maybe more.
Just take it all and get out.
A shovel. That's what I found, a shovel. Many shovels. And table. A tankard. Oh my god, what do these people eat?
Apple.
Nah, they don't, they have, I had one apple, just the one in the whole city. So this is the room of the Jarl. We got it. We got to the
See,
Jarl room.
He has a lot more books.
Yeah, he had some books, a basket. Yeah, that is some high quality loot.
Look at that bed.
An empty chest. Yeah, that is the best loot ever. And there is a...
I mean, he's a simple man. He doesn't need anything more.
Yeah, salt pyre. He eats salt. Yeah, that.
You have bread.
With
you
bread.
Have salt.
So bread with salt.
You have some spare pocket.
The Song of Five Kings Vulgar.
You read.
Yeah. At least Rusty Argonian Maid or something, man. Just, you know.
Look.
Under the bed or something. Nah, nothing here. See, I hate him even more now.
He's a simple man with simple needs.
Still hate him. 15 gold, yeah. This is the richest man in Windhelm. See, here there should have been a secret. Looks like it should have been a secret. See?
Yeah, that's just a different texture.
Yeah, I know, but that would have been nice to be a secret, to assassinate Ulfric from the back, you know? Oh my god, I would have enjoyed that.
What, you want to push him into the fire or what?
No, just, you know, let's say you could have assassinated him to end the civil war, just come from that place, you know,
a secret tunnel.
That would have been nice.
Directly route to his room.
Yeah, and kill him while he sleeps. That would have been a nice quest. Pretty nice quest. Okay, so let's go Palace of the Kings. We are here. We stole everything from here. We have stole everything from here. We stole everything from every last person and guard. Yeah, from Windhelm. Let's go to the bridge, and that will be a wrap. So we go where everything started from. We end it where it all began. Right? Okay, cage. Serving time in jail causes... I never serve time in jail. Oh, op. I see a guard. So there's a guard that I did not steal from. I'll take a trip around the city just to see if we can find another guard or something. But I think we stole from all of them. Okay, so the guard is naked. This is the thing.
Finally,
I found the wall. Looky here, my friends. This is the pinnacle of Bethesda bugs. I don't know how this could happen.
This is not a bug. This is the wall from Attack on Titan.
It is an Easter egg, right?
Yes.
It was done
years before.
Yeah. This is where Attack on Titan drew the inspiration from, I guess. The wall in Windhelm. Okay, so Sophie's selling flowers. Let's see guards. No guard here, of course, because nobody cares about... Why do you have... I already stole from you. I did not steal from... Okay, this is why we do the run around the city. Okay. Here, what he says. Okay.
I was one of the best soldiers in the Stormcloak army until I took a sword to the chest.
See, he's the only one that did not take an arrow to the knee. He took a sword to the chest. So this is pretty fun. We should put this at the beginning, you know. The only one. The only...
One in Skyrim that took a sword to the chest, not an arrow to the knee. Okay. He was a beggar. A beggar with a mace. Nice touch. Okay, and another guard should be there. And another guard patrolling. So if those two are pickpocketed, all is good. We pickpocketed all these nice people. What about you, guard? What? Why do you have only these items for you? What? What happened? What happened?
Is he a unique NPC?
No. He, I think Todd starts giving them their items back. Just one by one. I don't understand what, how is it possible? Let's just steal it, everything from him, and then the wrap. If we find the right position, that is.
Drive from this side.
Just become invisible. Just stop seeing me. Just go 3 hours.
That's too much.
No.
Get away from me.
Get away from me.
Come on, who sees me? That lady sees me, and that guy sees me. Come on, 1 hour, it's okay. Come on, there is no light left. 1 more hour. There's another guard that doesn't have any weapons. Do you have items on you? No. So, okay.
I know you.
You don't know me. 1 more hour. Or we did not steal from him. Oh, wait. He's leaving.
I know you.
He's
just
leaving.
Follow him.
I'll do that. I'll do that, don't worry. Hallefrost farm outside the city. You are naked. A bit dull.
Get away from me.
Okay, you go.
They say Ulfric Stormcloak murdered the High King with his voice, shouted him apart.
Okay, it's good. Apparently, there was one guard left, so now he has. Now he has all the items on him, you see? I don't know what happened, right. But I think this is the last one, yeah.
Next time,
okay.
I might not be.
Yes! Yes, so
hey,
let's see. There should be two more guards. One guard patrolling here. No weapon. So you good. And two more guards in front of the palace, and that's that. And that's a wrap. Because we know everyone. So we have to be thorough to be sure that we took all the guards. So yeah. Definitely stole from you. Yeah, from you. Don't have anything on you. And let's go outside. And that's that! Okay. You don't have a weapon. Okay. We stole from everybody. We stole from you. I stole from you. Okay. And wrap.
Finally. Finally it's done.
What? It did not take that much.
Only 3 or 4 hours.
Well, this is how much it takes, man. This is how much it takes for the fans, for the people, for the masses. This is how much it takes, man. This is how much it takes. Look, the brothers are here, are back. Okay, save the game. And that's it.